And then we got to say hi to Louis C.K. here.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi, guys.
Louis, good back.
Morning. Good morning.
And good Louis, morning.
You're playing part of the comedy festival here in New York?
No, well, yeah, I'm doing a couple of shows here. And then I'm in Vegas next week for the Vegas Comedy Festival.
We're on in Vegas, so there you go.
Are
you
I'm out there, too.
Are you?
What are you doing out there?
Me and David Hell are doing a show on Thursday night, the two of us. And then I'm doing Comic Relief also.
Oh, nice, man. Saturday. Jesus.
Yeah.
This is just traveling minstrels.
I know.
You guys, you just wander the land, spreading laughter.
I'm out there with our friend Saget. I'm doing Bob Saget's show in Vegas and with Jeff Ross.
Yeah, he's doing like a dirty show, right?
I know. I get stuck on a late night show. It starts at 1 in the morning. I'm on last. I'll be on at 2:45.
It's because you're foul.
The language.
That's all right. They're all sober by that point.
I'm going to work totally clean.
Yeah, you should do it tonight.
All corny, awful political jokes.
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah.
Well, your Comic Relief is live, right? Isn't that live on HBO?
Yeah. Yeah,
that should be great.
Ooh, yeah, it should be fun.
And they haven't done that in years now. Like,
I think it took a few years off. Yeah,
took a few years off. They got to find a new cause, I think.
Yeah,
right?
There weren't any more homeless people. They fixed it.
Yeah, we fixed the homeless problem with first one.
Ah, they realized people in general don't care about the homeless.
I earned that cake.
I
earned that cake. Why do you step on it?
That's why they're homeless, because nobody cares about them.
What's the,
if anybody cared, they put them in a house.
The homeless don't even care.
No, they don't.
You know, why help someone that doesn't care?
What was that catchphrase they had?
What?
They had like, because it's not a laughing matter.
It was, no, it was, here's some money, bum.
I remember, like.
There's always that line they have to cross, too. Like, you know, if you walk into a store.
Yeah.
They say that nobody, either they say nothing or they welcome you into the store.
Yep.
But there's bums that they walk in. As soon as they walk in, they go, hey, get out of here. Like, get out. They don't let them in anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
There's got to be a thin line in there somewhere where you just reach the, you sleep outside 2 days in a row and they start telling you, all right, take a walk.
You got to give them a little bit of time, though?
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah.
I don't know. Because I can still, like, I can go to a hotel and, like, use the bathroom and even ask to see a room and they'll let me in there and...
The latest
that white credibility, you know.
I can't. I feel guilty going into any place and using the bathroom without buying anything.
What?
I do. Like I feel like I'm gonna get not so much guilty. Wrong word. Yeah. I feel like I'm gonna get thrown out.
Okay.
Before I make it to the bathroom.
Like they take your poop and throw it out.
Yeah, get out of here.
Take this with you, you bum.
Like it's a lot of places say no use of the bathroom unless you buy something kind of thing. It's like,
a place in New York. I went to the bathroom. I go, where's your bathroom? They go, it's $1. And I thought he was joking. And I came out. I had to pay the guy $1.
I'd rather have that, though, than
sneak
around.
I would do that in a second.
Like they throw you out, and you know how usually in the movies, then the hat comes afterwards, but your poop comes flying up.
Comes, hits you in the head, and stay out.
Hey, I got a homeless guy that sleeps outside my my place.
Yeah.
He's a black guy. He sets up a mattress. I don't know where the mattress goes during the day, but every morning when Kenny, that's not Kenny over there, Kenny picks me up, homeless guy right outside my place on a mattress, and he wears women's clothes.
Oh, yeah?
Black guy. Black guy, women's clothes, homeless, outside my place every morning.
Is he passable, or does it look like a guy?
Oh, no, it's just ridiculous. I don't even...
Jimmy's thinking, why do you have to sexy it up?
Comes with his own mattress. I mean, my God.
Yeah.
I don't even think it has anything to do with his sexual orientation. It's just clothes that he's found and said, what the hell? Might as well just wear this.
These are warm. Screw it.
That's the feeling I get from this guy. So.
What's the cause? For Comic Relief.
Katrina.
Oh, it's really not homeless people anymore.
No, it's Katrina.
It's Katrina. They're trying to do another Katrina.
You still need a relief for that? I thought that was all fixed.
No, they're giving the money to Houston.
It is, but they just...
It's a good cause.
It's pro-Katrina. It's like...
It's for it.
Yeah.
It's for re-flooding the city.
It's for doing another Katrina.
I get it.
They should throw the money to Houston for crime fighting.
Yeah. They realize they need another flush.
Yeah.
One more flush should do the job.
Sledgehammers for the levees.
So, Louis, we're talking about, Brittany getting the divorce. We're talking about the elections.
Yeah.
We haven't talked about Doogie Howser coming out of the closet.
Yeah.
Is he gay?
That was a surprise.
Yeah. Why did I ask that? When he said Doogie came out of the closet, what else could that mean?
Quite literally. It's a new term in Hollywood. He's been lanced.
What?
That's what they're calling it.
Yeah, well,
when you're forced to come out of the closet, it's you've been lanced.
Yeah.
That has a couple of meanings, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Could mean being lanced.
I had something lanced once.
Yeah,
I did.
Yeah, you get something poked into it and it leaks. Yeah. Fairly accurate.
Yeah, exactly.
So we got the Doogie coming out of the closet, and now we got this great story in front of us from what, Dublin?
Wait. Doogie, quick question. How was he lanced? How was he forced out?
People started saying he was gay, and so he said, yeah, I am.
Yeah, some people fight it.
Yeah.
Like Jim J. Bullock.
Yeah.
He fought it for years. He's still fighting it.
That he's straight.
And Tom Cruise, of course.
Well,
still fighting.
Yeah.
He's putting up the good fight.
He's doing it.
I mean, we don't know, obviously, but, you know, come on. Something's going on there.
Yeah.
All right. So what about this story in front of you, Anthony?
Yeah. Dr. Sutton sex case. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Why not? Is this one of those guys who just couldn't take it? Where is this? Dublin?
Dublin,
Ireland?
I don't know if it's Dublin, Ireland.
Might be.
No, because they're mentioning San Francisco and Oakland in this story.
Dublin, Ohio.
Oakland, bitch.
Well, I said San Francisco and Oakland, so why would you say Ohio?
I mean...
Just blurting out
in America.
Most people would assume if I said San Francisco and Oakland that there has to be a town called Dublin somewhere in that vicinity.
It's the San Francisco Gate.
Well, Rich has heard of Dublin, Ohio, which is in America. That's just in his defense, it did pop in my head, too. I just wasn't stupid.
He likes to show that he has some kind of knowledge.
Yes.
You were smart enough to keep it to yourself.
I'm only a little smarter than him.
He likes to show people that he has some kind of knowledge. It doesn't matter if it's if it's not part of what we're currently discussing.
Yeah. Why don't you just yell that pub in L.A.?
He could get laid off of having said Dublin, Ohio. Somebody might think, wow, that dude's really smart.
I thought you were saying...
Yeah, he's knowledgeable.
This is what I thought. You said Dublin, Ireland.
Yeah.
I thought you were saying Dublin, Oakland, or San Francisco. You know, you're naming the cities where there's a Dublin, or... You know what I'm saying?
All right, now I can't.
Even Lewis,
he's trying. Now he's trying too hard.
Oh, he's out!
Police searching for a Dublin doctor says they say sexually battered two men at his home and took hundreds of photographs of 19 patients who were unconscious and undressed at his medical clinic.
Oh,
oh my God.
Saucy.
Tony Hsu?
He ran a private practice. So I guess out of his home? Is that what's
out of
going
his
on
home.
Here?
Well, you could see this kind of a Dr. Tony Hsu, some Asian gentleman.
So he
ran a private practice.
Wait till the patient's unconscious.
Yeah.
Take their clothes off and photograph them.
Well, maybe they voluntarily. Maybe that was part of whatever procedure they were getting done.
Allegedly drugged two men at his Dublin residence in August and then raped one of them, Dublin police sergeant said. A search of his home turned up 450 photos of 19 male patients who were unconscious and semi-nude in medical examination rooms. The doctor came under suspicion after two alleged victims reported to police that Hsu had drugged them as they visited his home. One of the men had known Hsu for years. The other met him that night.
How awful is that when your doctor rapes you? That's got to just be horrible. Who do you turn to?
Well, got the rape kit right there.
You got to go back to him to stitch you up.
No, I went to get some dental work done, and they knocked me out, and I woke up with a sore throat, and I was really certain that somebody did me in the mouth.
Really?
I was sleeping. But the way I look at it is if you have people come into your office and you're knocking them out, how do you not at least lick their face? How do you not give them the finger right to their face, lick their face?
Something.
Yeah, something.
We were talking about how doctors are just people. They're guys. They get a little worked up. Mm-hmm. And if you're a dentist and this beautiful woman comes in and now she's completely knocked out, you're alone in there.
We call it the perv switch.
The perv switch.
Everyone has it.
And some people get turned on.
It makes people pervs. Opportunity does.
You're just sitting there with your little pick going, I'm going to bicuspid problem here. We're just going to, I've got to see those cans. I got you just lose your mind and then rip her shirt open.
Yeah,
and you got to fondle.
And you just lose everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, you start laughing at her boobs. And
She's unconscious. Yes, we've got the number 8 molar on the top. I'm seeing the... Oh, gosh! I got to grab her crotch.
I just have... Click. She's unconscious right in front of you.
Of course. And then you...
Just breathing heavy and her boobs are just rising.
Yeah, yeah. You know? They're heaving.
And you're just trying to control yourself.
I think that's how most men would use any superpower, you know? That's how we would use anything.
That's about as close to a superpower as you can get.
Yes, it is.
You are knockout man.
Yep.
You can just, they come to you with the total knowledge that you will knock them unconscious.
Yes.
And that's it. You just got to make sure you button the shirt right. You ever button your shirt and it's uneven at the bottom and you go, oh, what am I do? You got to make sure you don't do that to her.
They always fumble and put it. They put both breasts back in the same bra holder.
Yeah.
They just fumble nervously.
Always a screw.
They got to put it back quickly before she wakes up.
I woke up feeling like something had happened. I felt like dirtier in some way, and then I realized my bra was on where my panties belong, and vice versa.
Tapioca in my hair.
They don't clean it when you're getting knocked out. If you're a woman, if you're getting knocked out by the dentist, you should write, you know, you pig on your boobs.
So that, or I have AIDS.
Yeah, welcome to the world of AIDS. Like you can get AIDS from looking at a sleeping woman's boob.
That would freak you out, though, if she had a message for you.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, but you say, where do you draw the line? How about the guy that works, you know, at the funeral home, who's in the room by himself all the time, you know?
Well, those stories happen, too.
How do you not? How do you not?
That, it depends on how fresh it is, I think.
Yeah.
And how they died. If it's if it was a bad fire, you might want to let that one go.
I love how Jimmy says might.
You might well, yeah, might, but then again, it's,
yeah, then again, you know.
A lot of no sex is curiosity, a lot of sexual urge. How many, you know, boobs that have been on fire have you seen?
Sure, what would it be like to have sex with one? Beef jerky?
Yeah, exactly.
There's
well, that's easy to find out.
A few guys decided they saw a woman's obit in the paper, and she was attractive. They found her grave.
Yeah.
We're in the midst of digging up her grave. One guy wanted to have sex with this dead woman. So he gets two of his friends who
his
weren't going to have
friends. Come on.
Yeah. Come on. They were going to dig her up so he could take her home and have sex with her.
Wow.
And then, based on the picture in the obituary.
And then the host from Dateline walked out. What are you doing here?
Are you going to have sex?
Oh, I was just going to dig her up and hang out with her.
Having sex with a corpse.
Why would you want to do that? I mean, I'm a pervert.
Why would you want to do that?
Those are good friends.
That's
no kidding.
That's the worst.
All right, look, dude, I understand, sure.
Yeah, I get you. You know, she is hot.
Yeah.
I'm not going to join you. I understand she's your chick, dude. You know, bros before dead hoes.
I'll do the digging and you can
use it. It's tough to talk your friends into moving a couch when you...
Yeah, how the hell did they talk these guys into, you know, I want to dig up a chick because I want to have sex with her.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Ugh. Like, Jordan. Is there a point where you go, like, are they going to go for this? Like, you got to really know your friends.
Yes.
You had to have been through some other stuff. You don't just work yourself. You don't go right from, hey, you know, you want to go out, drink a few beers to dig up this dead chick so I could have sex with her.
And her friends go, is she having an orgasm or decomposing?
How do you break that to your friends? Like, do you say it as a joke? And like as you're
and
all
you
laughing,
going, but seriously though,
you look and you're not laughing, you're staring at him over your beer.
Well, they must have some
with
history.
Shovels.
They must have history. Like, well, come on, remember the time I helped you drink that homeless guy's urine?
Yeah, there's got to be something in their history. All of them.
I helped you wipe that kid's blood off your bumper. All right,
remember? Dude, a hair, and you would have been caught on that bumper.
Hey,
and we helped you clean the whole thing up. All right.
At least the guy didn't want to have an orgy. You know how much digging that would have been that night?
Oh. Hey, let's go to Kelly and Syracuse.
Boss.
Kelly.
Hey, boys. How you doing?
Pretty good, Kelly.
Hi.
I had a friend that when she was younger, she was molested by her older brother. And so she was going to a shrink in order to get help with that, and her shrink was molesting her.
Well, wait, how old was she that he was molested? Was she an adult or was she a kid?
She was a teenager when the shrink was. He was hypnotizing her and then molesting her.
Well, her brother didn't shrink. What was she wearing? I mean, you know, sometimes they bring it on themselves by the way they carry themselves,
Kelly,
and walk around.
You're not going to find sympathy here. You realize how hot that sounds, right?
I know.
Well, again, why be a shrink if you're not going to molest the vulnerable?
Why hypnotize a woman if you can't convince her?
Hypnotize? That's the whole point of hypnotizing anyone is that they're a woman and you're going to touch their bodies with your penis. That's the entire point of the exercise.
So what ended up happening there, Kelly?
I think there just ended up being a lawsuit, but I figured you guys would find that pretty hot that she actually got molested.
You throw away the coin and just swing a bag in front of her face. You're getting sleepy.
How did he get caught?
he ended up, he was molesting quite a few of his patients, actually.
Yeah.
It turned out that he was molesting quite a few of his patients.
But they were kids, though, or like 19-year-old, 18-year-old
girls? Sounds like she was growing up.
They were like 13, 14.
Oh, well, now I recant everything. Unacceptable.
All right, let's go to Matt. He's a dentist in Georgia. Matt, what's up?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
You know, I just have to, I'm on the way to work listening to you, and just brought back memories for just a second of a this past summer when it's really hot outside. These cheerleaders, they come in with these midriff T-shirts.
Oh, my gosh.
These frickin' gym shorts, and she's laying back in the chair.
Yeah.
And I lay her back, and you know how their hip bones, how high, when they're skinny as hell, their pants kind of come up.
Yeah, they kind of ride on top, and you can see right down there.
Oh, my God. And I'm laying there.
He's a dentist.
And mom's in the room with me.
Good thing.
She's 17 years old. And I'm,
who, mom?
Oh, no.
Oh.
No.
Kids mom too.
Nowhere near. But
you know how the dieties ride up?
Doesn't mom know, though, when she's got a hot daughter like that? Doesn't she look at you when the kids asleep and go, go ahead, man, I know. Go ahead.
She's sitting there daring me to. And I mean, I'm working. I'm kind of halfway looking down.
Mm.
And I look down and her eyes are looking straight at me.
Yeah. You're thinking of a whole different root canal.
Wait. You know a dentist is up to something when they come in for a cavity and he pulls all her teeth?
Watch it out, guys.
Wait, dude, who was looking at you, the girl or the mother?
The girl was looking at me. The mom was sitting in the corner of the room.
So you're taking peeks as you do your work there?
It's impossible. I mean, you're laying them back. They're laying essentially in your lap, and a lot of these ladies come in with low-cut blouses on.
Yeah, but see, you said in the summer in their cheerleading outfits, they don't wear outfits, cheerleading outfits. That was your fantasy, right? Yeah,
this guy's got a pervert switch. This
very
close to the surface.
We all do, though. All right, thank you, Matt.
Staring you.
Let's say hi to Dane Cook. Dane.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, have you ever been molested?
No, but those are some great stories.
Yeah. Gotta watch the dentist.
We were talking about the perv switch. Everyone has one. You know, you get these stories in the paper where the dentist is molesting the patients when they're under.
My feeling on molestation is that, like, right around third or fourth grade, like, it should just be mandatory you're molested.
And that way everybody will have dealt with it.
Everybody's got a fair deal. We've all been diddled somewhere or another, and we can all say, you know what, I know the feeling. Let's just move on. We got it.
Even fat kids?
No. That kid should not be molested. Just they have to go to therapy and cry about how nobody touched them. One more humiliation.
Well, you gotta think.
Fat plate.
You gotta think there were people growing up that wish they were molested, and no one paid attention to them.
That wish.
No one paid attention to them.
I don't think there'd be a wish.
Daddy, I'm going to take a shower now.
Right, go ahead, don't bug me.
Doing everything you can, and no attention's being paid.
I can't get the water temperature right. Could you help me? Ask your mother.
Damn.
When I was a kid, my grandmother goes, "What makes you so funny?" And I go, "A small penis." And my grandfather goes, "No, you don't have a small penis, but your brother does, right?"
Yeah, you got a laugh for
that. Yeah, you got a little. I think that was a courtesy laugh from Dane.
Selling out the garden.
Yeah, Dane, what's up, man? Selling out the garden. What are you doing?
I know. I'm like thinking about adding a third show.
Are you kidding?
I'm just kidding. I'm not kidding.
All right. Jesus. Because you got a lot of people jealous to begin with. The garden show sold out in a day, so you added a second day?
Yeah. We added a second show. I think I don't know how many seats are left, but there's a few. There's 2,000 or 3,000 seats left.
Wow. Yeah. Wow.
It's only the garden.
Man. It's pretty loony.
And how many movies are you in the next month?
I'm finishing my, this will be my fourth one in a row that I'm finishing now.
Jesus Christ.
Down here in Rhode Island with Steve Carell.
Jesus.
And what's this film about?
It's called Dan in Real Life. Me and Steve are brothers, and we come home for a family reunion. He's a widower who falls in love with this girl that he meets at a bookstore, but he doesn't know she's my girlfriend. So when he finally comes home for the reunion, there's a little love triangle going on because we're both trying to keep the girl close to our hearts.
Are you like the dick in this whole one?
No,
he's the nice guy, and he'll wind up getting the girl, even though the girl would run off with you first?
No, we're both. That's the thing, is it's kind of like one of those things you don't know who she should be with, because we're both nice guys who end up kind of having to outdo one another.
She goes to the dentist and gets molested.
This is a hard pitch. This sounds like a great movie right now, doesn't it? this is a real panel one, isn't it?
This is a good one. This is one that you decided you were going to go for something a little different.
There are puppets in this one. I'm no
puppets.
Hey, what was the Kevin Costner flick you did?
Mr. Brooks. Yeah, that comes out I think in March. That's like a I guess it's kind of like a Seven or a Silence of the Lambs. He plays a serial killer called the Thumbprint Killer. He only kills couples while they're doing it, and I play this guy who I'm like this deviant nobody who takes pictures of him while he's doing it, and then I blackmail him into teaching me how to be a serial killer, or I'll expose him. So,
well, doesn't he know you're taking pictures of him? That would tip a serial killer off when the flash is going off while you're murdering someone.
No, I catch you. He doesn't know that he left a curtain open in a hotel, and I'm across the street. I was taking pictures of a couple while they were doing it. So he got caught because he screwed up.
The darker side of Dane Cook now coming out in these movies.
Yes.
I like this. See, you don't want to be typecast as the goofy guy in the movie. So now you're starting to take on these other roles.
I think it's a smart move. I wish
definitely.
Eddie Murphy should have played a rapist or something completely out of character, but Murphy would never do anything like that. I'm like, why doesn't he one time do something that is completely unexpected, and he never did it? It's always the fun, happy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure Murphy wants to take career tips from you. That's
Look, I'm not saying that I have a lot of movies, but I'm saying that Eddie
you
Murphy
have none.
Did kind of. Yeah, that's all right. Let's wait a phrase.
Let's get a line.
All right. I tried to sugarcoat it. You actually had a number prepared.
Are you at some point? So, Jimmy, are you at some point going to play a human being?
How are you going to diversify?
Mix it up a little bit?
I'm going to play a faithful guy who actually looks in the eyes of the person he's sleeping with.
All right, Dane.
Beverly Hills Cop was actually on the other night,
yeah.
And I never noticed, and I always loved Beverly Hills Cop, but you notice how many times Eddie does his Eddie laugh in Beverly Hills Cop?
Oh, yeah.
It's
constant.
It's insane. It's every other line, he's like, yeah, there you go. Every other line.
Yeah, two guys walking down the sidewalk, he had to turn around, look, and give the laugh. Like, there wasn't enough laughs in the movie.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Dane, what's it like being in a business when you don't have to try to get to the next level anymore? Like when you're,
good question.
You're not, huh? You know, when there's no more struggle, what's it like?
What Rich is saying is, what's it finally like to make the jump from middle to headliner? Rich, just ask. Don't be ashamed of yourself.
Co-middle.
Yeah, what's next for Dane Cook?
Oh, man, it's, you know, that's the weird thing. Once, this last year, it's just been so fast, man. Everything for so many years was about scraping, you know. It was like, all right, what do I got to do? And then to have all these things having taken place, it's just kind of, it's kind of weird. You know?
Here's what Dane's career is. You know what it is? Steve Martin. It's Steve Martin. You shoot to this unbelievable height of fame with your comedy, and then you go into acting, and then at some point you'll turn into a completely white-haired ass.
Yeah, and you'll do Pink Panther.
Yeah, and do Pink Panther movies.
Yeah, if you see Steve Martin out there, do me a favor and just lop his head off for doing that, and just yell Peter Sellers as you're hacking through his stupid neck.
Yeah. But he's got to be like, nah, but the guy's great. I think Dane doesn't want to say anything bad about anyone in Hollywood. You're a smart man, Dane.
Oh, man.
Don't burn those bridges. Got a few bridge burners here.
All right, so Dane, you're playing the Garden on Sunday. Tickets through Ticketmaster.com, right?
Yes. This Sunday night, two shows at the Garden.
Two shows at the Garden. That's
very nice.
All right, Dane.
And there's rumors, though, that people are saying that Dane was going to stop by the Hammerstein Ballroom on Friday night and do a spot on my show.
Oh, yeah? Oh, that'd be nice.
That might have been good if I just said it without a bubble of a fruit bubble in my throat.
That was your big opportunity to get a nice rumor started.
No, he won't do that. I can't even start that because the rest of my tickets will sell immediately. It'll be all hot chicks who vomit when I walk out and they realize it's not true and they just leave. I can't have that rumor started because they'll leave immediately when they realize that after Nathaniel, it's me.
Well, you got Artie on the show. There's going to be hot chicks there for Artie. How many...
Artie Fuqua, I don't know how he does it. All he does is have hot chicks. It's
12
disgusting.
Inches. That's how he does it, 12 inches.
Yeah? Yeah, yeah. Artie's a legend.
All right.
You mean his penis?
Yeah. Why did I answer yeah? I actually answered yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Dope I am.
Yes, sir.
I don't think I think you're selling yourself short, man. I think women dig you.
Atta boy, Lou. Yeah. Thanks.
Nice work, Lou.
All
nice
right. Luck, Lou. Dane, thank you so much.
Anytime, fellas. You know it. Oh, yeah, and by the way, I was talking to Bobby, and he was saying something about, like, did you guys call my publicist, or was there, like, some kind of mishap? I don't want you guys, because Bobby was saying you guys were trying to get in touch with me. I was like, they can get me on MySpace before they can get me through a publicist.
Oh, really? No, I think we...
Bobby is an ass.
Yeah, Bobby's just...
Bob's just a pontificating dope. He's probably like, Dad, they tried to call you, Dad. Bob is just so happy that you pick up the phone when he calls now, because he's finished and he knows it. Bob Kelly is done.
They got the varnish on him.
Oh, he is absolutely finished. You know how annoyed I was having to hear Bob feel good about himself this year? Dad, the ticket count, shut up! Don't talk to me like you're a famous guy, Bob.
You guys can't be happy for anyone.
I'm happy for people. I can be happy for people.
But you just don't want to be happy when it comes to Bob Kelly?
Who am I happy for? Yeah, right. Happy for,
exactly.
Happy for. Why would I be happy for you, Voss? I'm happy for you. I'm sad for Bonnie. But that's what Bob would, but Bob this year was insufferable talking about his own ticket counts. Dane's on his second Garden show, and if he's calling in to plug a gig, that's your second Garden show. Stupid Bob complained about comedy. I wanted to bite Bob's fat Donald Pleasance face for about 9 months now. Why did you give him a shot?
I mean, Bobby's been struggling, and finally he had a good year. What's wrong with that? I stick up for Bobby. He finally had a good year.
Yeah, I like
he's
Bob
happy
Kelly.
For that. Why wouldn't you want to support Bobby? You know it's going to pass. He's down to 13 minutes, but he had a good year. I support Bobby, and I think
Bobby... Would it be up to 13 minutes if you're going for the 15 minutes?
Oh, you know, okay,
thing?
To be technical, you know the joke.
Well, you ruined the joke, though, because you said down to 13 minutes. That means only 2 minutes of his 15 has been spent.
Yeah, that's right.
We
wow.
have 13 more minutes of that jackass. Dave, you know, Dave! Stupid hands opening. How did you tolerate him on a bus?
I like Bob Kelly's one of those guys where I really like him. And I'm talking, I'm like, hey, what a great guy. And then he says something unbelievably stupid. And I'm like,
oh, yeah.
Punch him directly in his face.
You don't know where on Bob's face you want to hit him. It's like the nose is obvious, but his eyes are punchable.
His cheeks are punchable.
When I first got to know him, I said, where are you from? And he said, I lived in Medford, Massachusetts. Actually, I lived in East and South Medford. Like, nobody cares if you came from two parts of some town that nobody ever
heard of.
Like, Medford, we're all supposed to go, wow, much. Did you make all new friends? Did you see snow for the first time? You know, your dad must have been in the army. That's amazing if you south and just say you're from Medford, you fat piece of garbage. And I just met him, and I liked him. But I'm already swearing in his stupid face.
And the honest question would be, all right, well, why did the one step family reject you and send you to people they knew?
Yeah.
What had you done?
Yeah, to go from Southeast.
Dane,
you take him.
Just please, no more helping Bob Kelly. That's my only request.
I love Bobby because he goes from like calm to tirade in like 3 seconds about anything. He could get like the wrong flavor ice cream, and it's a 6.5 hour dissertation, loud with spit. Dude.
But he'll eat it.
I went rum raisin, dude.
Here's how dumb. This is why I tell you Bob is stupid. Because we were talking one time about John Travolta and about him like having planes, and someone was saying that Travolta had planes like way years ago, and Bob goes, "Nah, dude, it's ever since this whole new thing after Pulp Fiction." And someone's like, "No, he had them before." And the guy goes, and Bob's like, "Nah, dude, I'm telling you, it's brand new." And the guy's like, "I just saw a special on Travolta. He had them." And then Bob's like, "All right, dude." It's like he's just a pontificating fool. He's a fool. I love Bob, and I just realized that's what he is. He's a fool.
Fool. Leave him alone. Leave him alone.
I'm pro Bob Kelly this month because he called me upset. And
hold on. What was?
He called me upset the other day, and I'm pro Bob Kelly. I'm campaigning for Bob Kelly, and I hope his fame stays.
Did you give him advice?
No, I can't give anybody advice.
All right, good.
Bob's fame. He should have Challenger written on his shirt.
All right, we got to let Dane go. Dane's got interviews to do here. So, Dane, Sunday at the Garden, second show, Ticketmaster.com.
That's it.
All right, thank you, Dane.
Same, man.
All right, guys.
Dane Cook, everyone. We got to take a quick break. We're really late. We got Louis C.K. here, Rich Voss here. We'll continue. It's the ONA virus spreading across America.
I can walk on my hands.
I can fart and chew gum.
I play the oboe.
I can ride a unicycle.
I wear a bra and lace panties.
So your talent is being queer, Travis?
It's the Opie and Anthony Walkover Talent Show. If you have a unique skill, talent, music group, or physical affliction, we want to exploit.
You can email Steve at foundrymusic.com with your ideas, or you can just show up during the walk to XM and start shucking and jiving.
Shucking and jiving? Jesus, Danny.
I don't write this.
Hear what everyone else is talking about. ONA Uncut and Live, continuing the show on XM Satellite Radio starting at 9 a.m. Eastern. Visit xmradio.com to subscribe.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Welcome back to the Opie and Anthony Radio program here on 92.3.
Hey. No.
And also other places.
All right, good.
Plenty of places.
And, stuff. And Rich Voss, Louis C.K. hanging out today. And Louis just told me, Louis shot an HBO special, man, to be shown in January, an hour.
Wow.
Which is, I'm very happy for you, as slash jealous. So Louis shot an hour, and
that's my first
and we'll be on
hour.
Kind of release.
Yep. A lot of jealousy.
Nah, but
you,
I'm happy
Jimmy.
For Louis. I'm very happy for Louis. Really does, I'm happy for.
Well, I gave you a job.
You certainly did. I talk about depressing. Pamela just called me. She got my sweater back. The rich sweater from Lucky Louie had been sold off.
Right.
They sell your assets immediately. It's like a divorce.
Yeah, no, we had to get all our clothes. Yeah.
And Pamela bought my sweater and got my sweater for me. So
that's right.
I can wear that like when prostitutes come over. I can hope they recognize me. I can go, huh? Because I'm nude in my
Member?
Sweater.
Member? Member? What do they do with it?
They just sell it to like people who will use it for whatever.
Homeless? Or other...
So there's a company called It's a Wrap, and they just buy everything that a dead TV show had.
It's a Wrap.
It's a wrap.
And then what do they do with it?
They'd liquidate it. I don't know what they would have gotten for that sweater, you know.
But do they sell...
If there's any iconic stuff, they would put it on eBay and stuff like that.
That's what I was thinking. So they sell it to fans and stuff?
Yeah. So I took all my work shirts and all that stuff. Yeah.
I got to tell you guys, wherever I go, man, I was in Rochester for a few days, and a lot of Lucky Louie fans up there. And people you would never expect, like, you know, proper women that don't have a dirty mind. And I'm like,
that's
what?
The weird thing. It's mostly older people. There's always older in New York. Every corner I'm waiting for a red light, some older Jewish woman puts her hand on my chest kind of sexually and says, "You are wonderful." Like old Jewish ladies and old black couples, well-dressed, come up to me. And say that they love the show, and then take my wallet and stuff.
That was the problem. You just needed white people.
I didn't
a lot of white people.
There's more
to
white
enjoy
people
the show.
In America.
I didn't expect the soccer moms.
I just didn't.
You know, and that's what I see a lot. They come up and go, that show is so honest, and the language, it was real.
Well, when I started doing material about having a family on stage, I thought I was going to get booed for the stuff I was going to say, because I did it out of frustration. I didn't think it would be make me successful. I was going on stage and saying stuff like, now that I have a baby, I understand babies in the garbage. Like, I wouldn't do it, but for the first time, I get it. Like, I totally visualize it. And it's true, every parent, actually, your head goes to like, okay, who would know? Like, how many people have seen this baby? I'm like, oh yeah, they got her footprint at the hospital. I forget it now, it's not gonna...
Could I explain it away?
They're gonna come around, hey, what happened? What, we didn't have a baby, what are you talking about? But so I would do jokes about that, and I thought I'd just get booed, and I was just doing it for my own... And soccer moms would come up to me after shows.
Sure.
And say, thank you for doing
this.
Thank
you, I did kill my baby.
I threw my baby in the garbage. I didn't realize how funny it is that I did, so.
Louis, what's the most frustrating thing about being a parent?
I think it's the spouse. I think if I was alone, I'd be fine.
Alone with a kid?
Yeah, seriously. I got two, and I sort of think in my head, because you do the virtual reality, okay, my wife dies, and the kids are still around, you know, to get a nanny. I mean, I could do it.
wait till your kid turns
16
and stays out all night drinking and lies at 16.
Oh, boy.
Not, though. The only thing that would be better is if I dropped her off.
All night long going from party to party.
Is that what's happening with the hot boss daughter?
Yeah, no, I haven't had any. I haven't started. That's a whole new level where the kid, the person actually has a life that you have to worry about.
Right.
And to me, I have two girls, so I just don't want them to depend on guys. That's all. I really don't care if they're hookers as long as, I guess that is depending on guys. But
yeah.
In a big way. A
hookers are not really independent of spirit.
Yeah. No. But no, the hard part is when they're babies, it's that you don't sleep and you really get on edge and you want to kill people.
Yeah.
And but there's endless reservoir of energy for the kids. I mean, they're crappy people. They don't care about you. It's a one-way relationship. They're mean-spirited. They smell bad too. A lot of the time, like my daughter won't bathe. And we have a baby, so we can't force her anymore. Like, we just go, fine, just sleep in your clothes. Nobody cares anymore. But she starts to stink. Like, she's got this little girl vagina smell that is kind of it's really hard to take. It's really hard. It's disgusting.
Do you have an Arab kid?
What's that? Well, if any kid, you don't wash them. They stink.
The reality is there's not much joy, right, when they're young?
Well, but there is. There's enough that it does makes all that worth. It doesn't bother me. Uh-huh. Like, she'll be really rude to me, and I think it's funny, and I'm proud of her. I want her to be rude and self-expressive. I want her to take from people and crap on them and abuse them, because that's how you get ahead in the world.
I can never understand when I see a father with especially daughter, mm-hmm. young daughters in a store or anywhere, and they go into that baby talk thing.
Yeah.
And it's like, Jesus Christ, this is a grown man who is now, you know, he was probably into, you know, he was under the hood of his car turning a wrench at some point with his buddies drinking beers, and now he's gooby baby talk. No, no, baby. No, darling, we can't do that. No, no. And you just look and go, what happened to you?
Yeah. No, I don't talk to my daughters that way.
No?
I just talk to them like, because that's stupid. It's retarded.
It really is.
Your kid, it talks like a baby because your kid is stupid and your kid doesn't know how to make real words yet. Your kid sucks at talking. So you're going to teach them by talking like them?
Yeah.
How dumb is that? Like, parents that take their kids' words, do you want Mickey? Say milk. So the kid learns how to say milk. So they can get a job. Don't retard their verbal development by talking like them.
The only people you should just baby talk on are the elderly.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Just to humiliate them.
Well, there was a little kid in my neighborhood, a little black kid, and his uncle, you remember Froggy from Courageous Cat, to talk like, wah, 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 like that?
No.
The uncle.
Hold on. You're not just.
Was that a talkie?
Did you just make up that cartoon?
No, Courageous Cat. You remember Courageous Cat?
No.
I'm going to tell you a good story.
I don't remember Froggy.
You watched cartoons when they were in black and white, didn't you?
Yeah. Steamboat Willie.
Jesus.
On a flip card thing like those?
Yeah.
It was a flip book.
He put a penny in the Nickelodeon thing and cranked it.
Turned his cap on backwards.
I go to Coney Island.
How old are you?
Are you serious? You don't know Courageous Cat and Minnie
Mouse? I remember the name, yes.
Yeah, I remember. I don't remember ever watching it.
But not Froggy, Rich.
He was one of the characters. He was one of the criminals.
And how did he sound?
He went, see, man. See, like Mug, you know.
Mugsy.
Yeah,
that was the
Right? Oh, my God. You know, if I close my eyes.
Wow. Yeah,
Froggy.
Froggy, he'd have a cigar in his mouth, a little cigar.
Yeah, I think Pixar is doing a Froggy movie.
Yeah, he's such a popular character.
Why am I being attacked from a show I watch?
I'll tell you why you're being attacked. Tell Louis what that event in New Orleans is.
Mardi Gras.
How do you spell it?
M-A-R-D-I Gras. Mardi Gras.
You finally...
All right, look.
Yeah,
he looked it up. Right, he looked the word up during the break.
He looked it up.
What did I say before?
He said Mardi Gras and Madri Gras.
No.
And he spelled it M-A-D-R-I.
Oh, you're out of your mind. I said M-A-R-D-I.
No, you didn't.
You don't think we tape this show every day?
I know
you
do.
It's on tape, my friend.
It's on tape. How much you want to bet? I'll take bets right now. How much you want to bet? You spelled it M-A-D-R-I.
I'll bet you.
I got 100 right now.
No, I can't gamble because I quit gambling.
Oh, that's right.
M-A-R-D-I.
Oh, you're lucky.
Come on.
That is the easiest money I would make.
It's not like drinking drugs. It's gambling. You can stop in a second.
No, I can't.
Come on.
You said Mardi Gras, and we asked you, and you said Madri Gras.
Madri.
Imagine if that's how you tumbled back down because of that bet.
Just one bet. Back to smoking crack.
black.
I was sure I said Marty, and I lost the bet, and I had to go make up for it at the OTB. And Bonnie left me 3 months later.
It would take a week for Voss to be on his knees pleasuring someone for a vial.
Because he misspelled a word.
People are saying here it's the frog you tool. Froggy was from our gang.
A frog or Froggy, whatever. If you talk to him,
Frog, you tool.
Well, if you talk to him in past tense, it was Froggy.
All right, so let's get to your story.
Well, it doesn't matter.
This is how old this cartoon was. The character was just called The Frog. Right. The first frog ever on a cartoon. It wasn't Kermit the Frog or Froggy.
No.
Just The Frog.
Frog, and people were fascinated by it back then.
A frog who speaks?
It's a frog?
How do they do it?
All right, so what happened with the frog?
We're talking about kids and how you talk, baby talk. Mm-hmm. It's not a good... The kid, the uncle.
As the Doughboys were headed to Europe, Froggy makes the movie screen.
Yeah, see?
The uncle would talk to the kid in that voice, the little kid. And the kid grew up, he would talk regular and then break into that voice.
Like Froggy.
Yeah, but not know it. So that's how he really talked. He would go from talking like a real person into
Jesus
Froggy.
God, please let this story have an ending. Please, I'm praying.
Please, God, let it see, have some kind of ending, see?
Courageous cat.
Hop.
And then this kid grew up and he bought a club in Philly called Helium. No, I don't know. All right.
You tased Rich.
I sure did.
That frog story. It could be, though. I've heard Al Zarqawi stories that had funnier endings than that.
Why don't you hop on out of here, because we're done with you today.
First of all,
let me explain something. Every story doesn't have to have a punchline when you're talking about kids and you're throwing
punchline. I'm not saying it should have a punchline.
I got a little water in my mouth on that one. Okay, let's come after me.
Take your lily pad and get the hell out of here. We're done with you.
I'm not saying it should have a punchline. I don't mean that.
Okay.
I just meant it was just kind of meandering, and it went from into boof.
Why don't you go play Frogger in traffic? How many frog jokes can we get out?
Plenty, I don't know.
I'm Voss, eh?
Hey, Kenny, Rich is hungry. Get us some flies. Frog, frog.
All right. That's a terrific story. Thanks.
Frog was a queer.
Let's say hi to Rich. He has an apology for Louis C.K. Oh.
Rich Voss.
Rich in New Hampshire.
Apology for everybody.
He's an apology for XM Canada. And go ahead, Rich.
Outside a toilet store with a mouthful of polywogs.
Wow.
Horrible.
There you go.
Meandering mess.
There you go.
You never disappoint, Rich. Thank you.
Love Rich.
You never disappoint.
Mouthful of polywogs. Oh, my God.
Oh, his stomach.
Oh,
that was a gem.
Yeah, right.
Should we go to New Hampshire?
Yeah, let's talk to Rich.
It's Rich.
Rich. Yeah, hey.
What's up, man?
I just want to apologize to Louie there.
Yeah, what for?
Well, I fell asleep at one of his comedy shows up in Massachusetts at the Kowloon, and my wife was telling me that he kept on looking over at me, and, well, I feel really bad about it now.
All right, hold on, Rich. I gotta stick up for Louie here. He didn't fall asleep because you were having a bad set.
Oh, well.
No, he passed out. No. He drank too much.
He drank too much.
Passed out at your show.
I just want to apologize to him for falling asleep at his show. Nothing that he did. I mean, I enjoy his comedy. He's great.
Dude, what we're saying is it's not falling asleep. Yeah. Up there it is. Up in New England, like it is. I just fell asleep. It's called passing out from alcohol.
There's a difference.
It's not falling asleep.
No comic wants to hear that you fell asleep at his show.
Kind of makes it sound like he took both of his hands, put them together like he's praying, and put his cheek on him at the table.
They don't mind hearing that you passed out at one of their shows, but...
Guy was drooling on his chicken wings.
He fell asleep like Alex in Clockwork Orange in the spaghetti. That was how he fell asleep.
Yeah.
I tried the line.
All right.
No, you don't have to apologize for something I was completely unaware of.
Oh,
but
okay.
Thank you.
Well, hey, no, I think that I do. Anyways, that's just me.
All right, thank you, Rich.
Thank you very much for coming to see me at the Kowloon.
I got
to
cut you short because this is the $100 I would have won.
In the Mardi Gras, you know how they have the heads on the stick?
In the what?
In the Mardi Gras, the heads on the stick.
And how do you spell Mardi Gras?
M-A-D-R-I.
Madri Gras? Mother Gras?
How do you spell M-A-D-R-I? Mardi Gras.
Oh, yeah, sure.
M-A-D-R-I.
Mardi.
Wow.
Mardi Gras.
You're not a real person.
There you go, from earlier.
There you go, Rich.
Okay, here's the deal. It was early, and I wasn't really awake.
The case is rested.
How early is it that you spell Mardi Gras, M-A-D-R-I?
I made a mistake, okay? What's the big deal?
Well, wow.
Only that you said you didn't.
Right, that was all. You said, yeah, I made the mistake, but then you totally went, I did not say it like that. Pull the tape.
Yeah, they could tamper with tapes, too.
Yeah, of course.
Somebody was back there cutting.
Like, all right, whatever, Rich. Jesus.
Man, it was the frog.
All right.
Frog got to my tapes.
Rich is great on a stage. Helium Comedy Club.
He's hilarious.
Thursday, he's a
very funny comedian.
Starting Thursday, Helium Comedy Club in Philly. Rich Voss, Louis C.K.
Vegas
on
Dave Attell.
November 16th, right?
That's right. November 16th.
And the 17th in Vegas.
Yes.
All right.
And me at the
Comedy Festival.
And Hammerstein. I'm going to that show, Jimmy.
Are you coming?
Oh, absolutely. Okay. I wouldn't miss it. It's the ONA virus spreading across America.
Opie, Anthony, Jim Norton, and the comedians of the Opie and Anthony Show are appearing in a special holiday edition of FHM on sale now.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's here with the Opie and Anthony radio program. We got some time left and stuff. We're on XM and also CBS and Citadel with Louis C.K. and Rich Voss and me and Opie and Anthony.
That was terrific, Jimmy.
Yeah, I got.
I think there's a couple more that don't belong to either.
What a problem.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think so.
Sorry, I'm developing a cough now. This is great. My girlfriend's sick, and now I'm getting sick.
Oh, boy.
See what happens.
Well, I think I infected her. I mean, we both have sore throats.
Oh,
by the way.
That would start.
By the way, AIDS free.
Oh, you took the test
Your test?
No, I'm giving it out.
Giving out AIDS for free? AIDS free. AIDS. Free AIDS, then.
You got to say it right.
I got my test, and I was good. And
you took it again? Aren't you so nervous when you take that thing?
Yes.
You don't get AIDS from the test.
No. Yes.
Don't take that test.
Yeah. Can we send a card? They got a card for that somewhere?
I'm
going to try to find a card for
congrats.
That.
Congrats.
Yeah, whatever
like
your
Hallmark
next birthday.
Card?
Yeah, Hallmark card.
Yeah, you made it.
Congratulations.
Wait, let me see. I have to get my gonorrhea results. That's all right. I have to get my gonorrhea and syphilis.
Oh, that's where you're going to have a problem. Yeah,
those are a lot more.
You're going to have one of those.
You'll have something.
Yeah, but you can see that stuff in your underwear. You can't see AIDS in your underwear. You know what I mean?
Jesus,
Rick.
I know, because I...
All right.
You know how you've got
you've got
a fine-tuned nose, like you can smell underwear. A little gonorrhea, chlamydia.
It's just a
under
hint.
The bouquet of.
He's like Hannibal Lecter. You wear Landed Comp and have syphilis.
We have to get this kid thing in before we get out of here.
Yes, please.
Really fast though. We're in the December issue of FHM. Ant and I and Jimmy, of course, and Voss is in there.
Otto,
with,
Patrice.
Got
Bill Burr.
Otto and George, Patrice. Yeah, Bill Burr and Bob Kelly. Is that it? That's the lineup. And E-Rock took a bunch of photos behind the scenes.
Yes,
and now
did.
We officially could get those up on our website, opieandanthony.com, so you can check out all the photos from the photo shoot that E-Rock was taking as the professional photographer. Photographer
done 1,000 pictures of Opie and everyone else.
So catch me and Ant in the background.
Yeah.
When you're done masturbating to FHM, you can read about the show.
Nice.
The photos are pretty cool because it's all behind the scenes stuff. All right, this could be terrific. Let's see how this goes. Grandma buys grandson scary children songs. This story starts out pretty normal, but
they're not supposed to be scary.
But wait for the punchline because it's well worth it.
We got a call from an irate grandmother who was so upset over an innocent gift she bought her grandson, she never thought it would affect him so badly. You may even own one yourself and not realize what it is.
What? Old grandma?
Debbie Jurgensen is a wonderful grandmother, but she's feeling awfully guilty these days because of a gift she gave her grandson.
To think that I gave this to him thinking it was going to soothe him to sleep, and then to find out that he went through 4 days of pure horror.
Happy ending.
And was hysterical crying every time he went in his happy little room, and it was my doing.
Believe it or not, the gift Debbie bought was this stack of children's CDs called 101 Toddler Tunes.
We started playing the CDs and putting them on at night for the little guy, and he wasn't sleeping too well. And then my husband thought it might be the music, and I thought he was crazy. Until one afternoon I put it on to play with him in his room, and there was a Ladybug song.
This is just one of the songs little Michael had been forced to listen to while he tried to fall asleep.
Got to fall asleep just by himself.
Yeah.
With the little stars on the ceiling.
And you know he's like scared of certain things in his room, little shadows. Maybe mm-hmm. the chair looks like a monster when the lights are out.
I thought he was crazy. Your father's getting no credibility. It's like we just started playing some music. Maybe it's the music.
What are you, crazy? What are you, crazy?
Are you crazy?
You're stupid idiot. Go
Everything
home and
else
earn.
Has been in that room
go to work and earn
born.
Money.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, well, something new was introduced.
Yeah, go put a
music.
Roof over our heads, you useless piece of crap.
It's funny you picked that right up, too, man.
Oh, yeah, that's what my radar is just. Yeah, shut up, woman. Yeah, mothers know everything except for nothing.
Let's look at it logically. What have we introduced to this child? Since he has had a problem sleeping. Yeah. The music.
Yeah.
Oh, stop it.
Oh, it's not the music that I haven't listened to yet. That I let him a stack of CDs. I haven't even listened to one of them because I'm lazy.
Well, here's the song.
All right.
While he tried to fall asleep.
Ladybug, ladybug, fly away home. Your house is on fire and your children will burn.
Will burn.
They will burn.
Why go home then?
No hope in this song.
Just go get a drink.
Give the kid a little hope.
Just take that money you're going to save from the following Christmas and buy yourself something nice.
Will burn. Ladybug, ladybug.
I can't believe this is what they say.
Over and over again, too.
How great is that?
Children will burn.
I love that they're trying to tell the ladybug to get home to save their but they're singing it so sweetly.
Yeah, it's such a nice, will burn, da-da-da.
Your baby's being raped. You know, you better hurry home.
Who knew this was going on, man?
The kids are all going to look like raisins with wigs.
Oh, <God. laughs>
Nothing worse than a burn victim wig. Because it's always this perfect, and it never fits the head properly.
It's slightly askew.
It always looks like a hat. Because there's that space between the wig and the awful head. It just, there's no way to fix it. There's nothing to integrate
space.
It with.
That's right. Nothing
there's no hairline.
There's no hairline at all. It's just like a stormtrooper hat.
Let's go to Rudy in Westchester. Rudy!
Hey, what's up, guys? How are you?
Hey.
I was watching that story on the news, and they showed a picture of the kid. The kid was absolute oblivious. He was in la-la land with this stupid look on his face, and he didn't know what the hell was going on, and the grandmother was going on about happy, 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 and horror, horror, horror. And it just seems so weird that this kid even had a clue as to what was going on with these songs. And it just, like, blew my mind because I didn't believe it at all. But it did run me into a state of paranoia and have to go, you know, listen to my kids' toddlers' songs as well now.
Yeah, nobody pays attention to what their kids are watching or listening
to. Or doing or playing on the computer or anything.
No,
it doesn't matter.
I was in a bookstore, kid's bookstore, buying some books for my daughter, and there was this older woman came in and said to everybody, it's a cheerful kid's bookstore in Hollywood. And then this lady comes in and asks the sales lady, I need a book for a 4-year-old boy whose father died.
They have that section.
They have a section for your dad just died, you idiot.
How about mommy's roommate?
Mommy's
mullet lesbian moves in.
You're moving into a small apartment with
the parade
mom.
Of uncle losers.
How about daddy had his brake lines cut and mommy has a new check?
How about reading insurance policy?
Yeah.
We got to go into these bookstores now and get some of these titles. Mm. All right, there's more to the story.
The children will burn. That's nice.
I was really disturbed because my father is a retired fireman who recently actually just lost a close friend. So she's starting to grasp the concept of, Jesus. You know, death.
Is he a ladybug idiot?
Is he a ladybug? My father's friend was recently swatted by a giant hand.
Yeah.
Who cares
so
if ladybugs die?
She's starting to grasp the concept of, you know, death.
I felt horrified because these babies are very precious to me.
And there were more tunes, like the little brown jug.
Oh, jug. Little old Jack called our own. She loved gin and I loved
rum. Boy, we had a lot of fun. I mean, this is a toddler song.
It's about booze.
This is a toddler song?
Come on.
And this one, Casey at Bat.
Kill him. Kill the umpire.
I mean, kill him? Kill the umpire? I mean, that's not
made
what
a
you
bad
say
call.
To children.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, obviously, you never had any money on a
listen
game.
To the listen to the CDs first, you idiot.
Yeah.
And what's wrong with that? The children? It's not like you're saying molest the umpire.
No.
Or offer the umpire money to get in your van.
kill him.
Kids.
No, it would have been funny during the whole interview where Ladybug lands in her hand and...
or an umpire walks in and she just yells at him.
Kill him.
Kill him.
Maybe this kid's not sleeping well because his family sucks. His whole family's a bunch of adults. And
bunch
he's
of
up night
idiots.
Going, how am I going to be raised by these jackoffs? How am I going to have any kind of a
doomed.
Life?
They're blaming the music and they're like, we didn't know if it was the music because I would drink a lot and my husband would hit me and we would scream and yell and we would wake up but we didn't know it was the songs.
Hey, the kid should be happy he has his own CD player at that age.
Yeah, no kidding. Jesus.
Now, one of the things you should know is that these nursery rhymes aren't exactly new. Some of them are classics, and they've been around for more than 100 years. In most cases, they were a history lesson, like when the ladybugs infested the fields of England, hence the song, Ladybug, Ladybug, Fly Away Home. So the big question now is, are the words in these rhymes appropriate for today's generation of kids and parents?
Ew.
Oh, God.
Ew. That's the big question.
We gotta attack everything.
The big question is, why does America stink?
Yeah, that would be the bigger question.
I'm just so tired of stuff like that.
No kidding. Nicole in New York.
How about London Bridge is falling down, but at least they're not jumping off it like they are the Golden Gate? Huh? That's the updated version for today's kids. Run with that. Get it. Production staff, go.
Do it.
My daughter, kids are supposed to not... My daughter and I were eating lamb chops one day, and she said... She's 3 years old at the time, and she said, what are we eating? And I said, lamb chops. And she'd been to a farm recently and petted a lamb. So she said, are there little lambs inside of this? And I said, no. I'd never made the connection with her that she eats animals.
What a stupid question.
Yeah, I know.
Are little lambs inside? Of course there aren't.
Yeah.
You
I go,
dope.
So I go, no. And she says, well, are these pieces of a lamb?
Ah, now she's catching on.
And I go, yeah, they are.
Yeah.
Just told her, yes. So we're eating a lamb like the one I petted? And I said, yeah. And she says, I like lamb chops.
Oh.
She's like Hannibal Lecter. No, she
didn't
likes
expect
eating
that.
Animals.
There you go.
She likes eating animals. She's full aware that she, you know.
Top of the food chain.
She loves ducks and she loves eating ducks.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did the lamb make you perform fellatio? Did he sodomize you? No. He was
a good lamb.
Hey, let's go to Nicole. She's got something pretty good.
Hi. I took my 3-year-old brother to the library and the librarian pointed me over to this section. I guess she thought I was like some unwed teenage mother. So there's like, why you had sex when you were 10. And there's a book about Uncle Willie's pickles and how to deal with molestation and why is daddy in a casket.
All right, wait a minute.
And they have
Hold on.
Why is daddy
I have an
in
assignment.
Yes.
I have to read Uncle Willie's pickles.
Yeah. Could someone go out and get Uncle Willie's pickles and get it over to XM for the second half of the show today?
Why is daddy in a casket sounds awesome.
Yeah, maybe daddy,
why is daddy
maybe
in a
daddy's
casket?
A bad driver. Or maybe daddy met...
Nicole, this is going to be much more exciting here.
Go ahead, Nicole.
This whole section is like in the middle of the children's playroom, like pictures of really tickling kids, like awful, awful books.
You know, I want you to have a sandwich just full of Uncle Willie's pickles.
The thing that bothers me is that people want to protect their kids from reality, but then they want to sell them stuff. Like that's what's acceptable is like Fox Kids, where they're selling them toys and cereal with loud noise and MSG and sugar. Like, nobody cares about that.
Yeah.
That's fine. But don't mention to them that things do die and that it's okay that things die, especially if it's your stupid father.
Well, the daddy in a casket thing does seem a little morbid. Like, how could that possibly play out?
Maybe this,
why is daddy in a casket? Well, he's going to be in it till bugs eat his face.
Yeah.
Daddy borrowed money from a man, and daddy couldn't pay him back. That's a lesson. Maybe daddy mingled with someone of a race that he shouldn't have. Here.
Daddy.
For the Brady kids, why is Daddy in such a lil casket?
Why is Daddy face down in a casket with a permanent arch in his hips? Well, you know, that man he played on TV.
Why is Daddy in a closed casket? Well, because his face is pulp.
God.
Because we couldn't reconstruct his...
No, maybe. I wouldn't play that.
Do you think there's room in our society for these old-time classics?
No, I don't think so. The kids today are smart, and they can pick up on things like that.
Well, you know what? 100 years, one complaint. That's not too bad. Okay? All right? That's true. A good track record.
That's true.
Good point, Rich. Good point. And Helium Comedy Club all weekend for Rich Voss.
And it could tie in, actually. We'll have to just change the update. How about immigrants fly away home? Huh? Give me those ribs, you.
Well, let's see what a child psychologist has to say about this issue.
Oh, good. There's nothing inherently wrong unless you want to do away with Snow White, Hansel and Gretel.
But child psychologist Dr. Victoria Beach doesn't understand what all the fuss is about. After all, she says, children have been listening to these nursery rhymes for more than 100 years.
Casey at the Bat was in 1888, and it was published in the newspaper. Very famous poem. Way over the head of toddlers.
Kill him! Kill the umpire!
Quite frankly, if you don't want your children to hear Kill the Umpire, you should never let them watch a baseball game.
And her advice to parents is simple.
Children will repeat what they hear. So if you don't want them repeating it, don't play it.
So for mom and dad, you heard the doc. The bottom line is pretty clear. Just use your discretion when it comes to your kids if you don't like what you hear.
Yeah, just let them listen to soulless Barney and Elmo.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Teach them nothing about anything and...
Or milk toast.
Don't chase him across the street in Crown Heights with him.
What is wrong with him? Hey, we gonna find that book for Jimmy?
Oh my God, Uncle Willie's pickles. It's all I
where's
I'm
that?
Obsessed with them.
We gotta find that.
Uncle Willie's pickles.
How many pickles does he have?
I know exactly.
He's got a bunch of pickles.
Well, I guess Uncle Willie had a lot of friends who also had pickles.
We're gonna do the walkover in a couple minutes here. So if you got that book. Come find us. We'll let you check out the second half of the show.
Let's throw rocks through the moneylender's windows. It's based on history. Come on.
Let's take their teeth.
Oh, send them to the camps. Send them to the... It's history.
Send them to the camps and their luggage will follow. Luggage will follow. Yeah, that's true.
Use the hair for soap.
Yeah, just because it's based on history, one person's like, well, these are based on historical. Oh, okay.
We'll drop,
that's good.
We'll drop leaflets, then bomb them.
Burn those shadows on the bridges. Burn the shadow.
Slaves are very useful.
They lift heavy things.
You get to own their children.
And you can examine their teeth first.
All right, let's get some plugs in. Rich Voss, thank you.
Thank you.
Helium Comedy Club all weekend long, starting tomorrow night, right?
Yeah, thanks.
It's a great club down there. We met the staff. They're really, really cool. And Louis C.K. in Vegas, November 16th and 17th.
Comedy U.S. Comedy Festival in Vegas, or whatever it's called, thecomedyfestival.com.
And Lowell Jimmy Norton.
Hammerstein Ballroom this Friday. You can get tickets at Ticketmaster, and it's actually selling very well. It's not sold out yet, so come down if you can.
Yeah, see Jimmy.
Let's get a last-minute push for Jimmy.
Yeah, it would be nice. Support your pal, old Jimmy Norton.
A bunch of us.
Bad news with a tumor. I don't want to talk about it until Saturday. Oh, by the way, there's an after party at Headquarters Strip Club, who are sponsors on this show, I believe. 50 listeners or 50 guests of audience members are going to get a VIP thing of open bar, which is a horrible judgment error.
Wow. Did they make a mistake?
And how are you going to pick those people?
I don't know yet. This just came about, but there's going to be an after party that I will be at Headquarters. And, wow, boy, say goodbye to that business. 50 drunks from this show.
No kidding.
What an error you guys made.
All right, if you're not joining us over at XM, have a great day. Louis, thanks. Are you joining us, or what are you doing?
Sure.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
All right. All right, let the cursing begin.
Yeah,
bye.
Go to XM. Whole point.
The ONA virus spreading across America. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you.
I just got wowed. It was great. I'm not supposed to talk about it, though. I gotta go now.
Introducing the
Opie and Anthony WOW line. If you get wowed, we want to hear about it. Call 866-WOWME-05. That's 866-WOWME-05. And tell us all about it. And if your message isn't too stupid, we might just play it on the air.
The Opie and Anthony XM walkover begins now.
Crappy day in New York City. Raining like crazy.
Disgusting.
It's raining. Time for the walkover to XM. Are we going to get that that kids' book? Children's book?
Ooh. It turns out it's not pickles.
I know. Oh, we got a copy already?
Which would be great.
We're
getting it. We'll get it.
Uncle Willie's Tickles.
Yeah, Tickles.
Uncle Willie's Tickles.
No.
And it's about
even
better. Because that means that Uncle Willie has been doing a little hands-on coochie cooing.
Yep.
And causing discomfort.
But we're going to get it? Oh, that's great.
Good old Uncle Willie.
What a trooper.
Yeah, they got to pour it on with a name, too. It can't be like Uncle Harold's Tickles.
Yes, it's got to be. They tried to
like
the
Uncle's Penises. It's like Uncle fucking Uncle Scrotum's ass fucks.
I don't think the Walmarts will carry that.
No.
Old Uncle Memory Repressor.
I don't think any uncle should tickle any child.
Ever.
Not at all. That's, just go right for the fucking.
It's not worth whatever the benefit is. You know? The possibility that he's fucking your kid in the ass. Just don't tickle my kid, all right, you faggot?
There's so many times on sitcoms and stuff that you're watching, and guys are so inappropriate with young children on the shows, picking them up and playing with them in a way that if you ever did that, you would be either punched in the face by the parents or arrested.
Oh, yeah.
But in sitcom world, it's totally acceptable.
Yeah, I know, exactly. I would never let my kid be an actor in a sitcom or anything.
No. It's another thing, yeah.
Some grown man is touching your kid.
Just because there's a fucking camera rolling doesn't mean...
Yeah, money's being made.
The kid's going to be fine with it.
No, of course not.
All right, stick your finger up the kid's ass.
The kid's like, hey, it's a
40.
The show.
The good news is she's paying for her own college. The bad news is she sleeps on her stomach for 6 weeks.
God damn it.
Look at Kenny holding the umbrella over Opie.
It's the Kenny's hair grabbing for the water thirstily.
That dry hair of his.
It's like a chia
pet. Oh, my God.
It's thirstily grabbing for water.
Thirstily.
All right, which way are we going today?
I say we cross right here, Opie.
Yeah? Well, look, the hand's blinking red, Jimmy.
Now
we got to go straight.
Oh, you should see this funny thing I say. It's about talk to the hand.
You're a scream.
Here we go. A mouthful of pollywogs. Wow, is that funny. Come on, Dan.
You're a big golf umbrella.
Does your umbrella have to be that big, ma'am?
How big are you?
What are you trying to do, keep your cunt dry? Get out of here, you.
Drop something. No? Can get her. Umbrella man, how's business? Business good?
It's cool.
All right. What does he sell when it's sunny out, Jimmy?
All right. I don't know. Probably bricks to other homeless people.
Crack.
You know, with a white lady's head diagram.
Best place to hit.
Let's walk. It's
strike here.
Oh, there we go.
It's a short walk today. It's just too miserable out.
It's miserable, all cold.
Miserable.
You want me to put my arm
around
you?
If it wasn't for those rainy days, you wouldn't appreciate those nice sunny days.
That's right.
Way to take lemons and make lemonade, Ann. Good point.
Yeah.
Is that hospital sign doing anybody any good up there?
Where is it?
It's
up here. There's a little triangle.
Wow.
What hospital is that for?
Is there a hospital sign?
What
is, we never
just
noticed
right here.
It.
It's like...
Yeah, look at...
Who's... Oh, thank God.
Where?
Oh, I almost died because there's no arrow.
It doesn't tell you where it is.
It's just a hospital.
We'll just stand by the pole here and hope someone gets
you. Just give
you
the idea. A hospital, that's a great idea because I'm dying right now. Where can I find one? The sign's like, I don't fucking know. I'm just mentioning hospitals.
That sign is no help.
No.
You start getting chest pains, you look up, all right, hospital.
Hospital, then, okay, but where? The sign's like, fuck you, you work it out.
Then you drop dead trying to figure out where to go. Wonderful. Only in New York. Mind your business!
Just a big yellow hospital sign.
Yeah.
Flea has the portable Pal Talk camera. Good?
Yeah.
They're filming us for the computer right now.
Portable.
Oh, my goodness.
It's like
they
the cell phone of 1983.
What can't
he's holding
they do?
A big fucking hip bag. Look at how big this umbrella is coming our way.
Isn't
it? Oh, my God. Is that necessary?
Oh my God.
Why is your umbrella so big, sir? That is as tall as you are.
Excuse me?
Why is your umbrella so big?
For the yard, you know?
11 of his relatives came to this country in that umbrella.
I think he stole it from someone's backyard. I think that was on a picnic table.
I think it was an outdoor cafe.
Did you hang a woman that was yelling at you for some construction work?
All right, go. Good point, Ed. Let's move on.
Does look just like the guy in the paper.
What's Tyra doing?
Oh, if only she was shutting up.
Why is Tupac still selling records?
Oh, my God. He's got another CD coming out.
Unreleased music features.
Oh, my God.
Has he been dead 10 years?
Yeah.
Yeah, 10 years he's 10 had. Years
I think there's a glory hole in here. Maybe.
Is that,
no?
Scrape away Tyra's mouth and you can stick your cock right in there.
By the way.
Might shut her up.
This documentary called Fuck, I saw it the other day. It's hilarious.
What is it?
It's a whole documentary on the word fuck.
Wow.
It's hilarious. We got an advanced copy. I checked it out at home.
Even the Janine Garofalo part?
That was a little shaky. I'm not going to lie to you. That was a little shaky. But the rest of it was really, really good.
I don't know if I go for that talk.
They talk about the FCC and George Carlin and the 730 words and what is the actual definition of fuck and all that. It's very, very good, I'm telling you, as far as documentaries go. Check it out, Ant.
Everybody taking shelter from the rain.
Ooh.
I don't like Voss's short jacket. It's like a waiter's fucking jacket. Hey, bring me some clam chowder, dumb Jew.
Right inside today.
Yeah.
See you upstairs.
I'm gonna pass her on the elevator.
They are the most vile, despicable human beings in the country. Creeps. Ankle biter.
Obviously, the strength is their ability to turn mistruth into something people would believe.
Wow, how long is this guy going to continue to babble and say nothing?
All day long!
Shut up!
All right, here we go.
Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's worse than I imagined.
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
We are a bunch of dopes.
I think we're lewd.
And we're probably pushing 20 arrests because of this radio show.
Out of touch, cornballs,
three retards.
We have the effect of Town Hall PM.
Opie.
You know I could have been a model.
Anthony.
I'm gay.
James Norton.
I like yogurt.
Robert Reed.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Hi. Sorry. How long did that go? That was like forever, right? Yeah, shit. We got stuck downstairs. One of the elevators was out of commission. And when they all work, it still takes forever. I think those are like steam-driven elevators down there. It's the worst elevator system in any building you've ever seen. They're always working on them. So it took forever. Jimmy cut a couple of good gassers. That's pretty good. That was entertaining, but that was playing for...
Well, there's something
10 minutes.
Up with the elevators. What was up with the elevators?
I don't know. There was one under construction.
Yeah.
Took forever. My God. It's not our fault, people. We want to come up here and entertain.
Why are they not?
I don't know, Jimmy. Not what?
I'm annoyed. I want the name of this channel to have Opie and Anthony in it for name recognition. Because I was looking at Oprah and Friends. Is Oprah and Friends? You know why?
Whose channel's that? Bob Edwards?
Exactly.
Oh, the Bob Edwards. That's his show and... It's Bob Edwards.
Wow.
Public radio.
We got a lot of dumps today.
Did we?
You want Kenny to do the dumps today?
I think so. Kenny's got charisma. He's got spunk.
Club Soda Kenny.
Dry hair.
Rich's mic for a minute.
No, he's not. His hair's looking
good. Whoa! Nice. Hey, what's up with this, by the way? I have no clue. Andy from London, England. Own A Experience podcast is number 18 in the iTunes video podcast chart. What is that?
Don't know. I'm actually not familiar.
And you know?
No, never heard of that.
You're usually up on that. It's a video podcast. iTunes video podcast chart. The ONA Experience podcast is number 18.
Oh, okay. Yeah, somebody turned our one of our videos, whatever it was, into some kind of downloadable podcast for your iPod.
Oh, nice.
And I guess it's doing well.
Pal Talk, Eric says. Young Hawk says Pal Talk.
Oh, Pal Talk video?
Yep.
Of what?
Studio.
Oh, and they just, like, podcast that every day?
Yep.
Oh.
Hey, sure. XM's going to be happy about that.
Please just punch, I'm sure.
All right, Kenny, time for the dump report.
Live from the Opie and Anthony Show studios, the Daily Dump Report.
Wait, look at Kenny's glasses.
I don't know.
You want me to try to
like Walter Cronkite when Kennedy died.
At
3:15 this afternoon, Jim Norton said cunt. A nation mourns.
Dab your eye. Take your glass off.
The glasses aren't even that bad. It's the fact that you don't have them all the way up when you read. Are they bifocals? Does Club Soda Kenny have bifocals?
No, I just need them for reading.
Ew. Why don't you take them off and try? I want to see how you do without them.
This one's for long distance, and then when I look up, I could beat a perp's skull in.
Well, it's like we were talking today. We were talking about somebody who did something he didn't like, and he goes, I told that guy, like, look, I took the heat. I didn't tattletale on you.
Tattletale.
He says tattletale.
All right, Serpico.
It's very demeaning.
All right, go ahead.
Tattletale.
6:42 a.m., that Canadian guy.
Yeah.
Fucking right on, fuck, and another fuck or two.
Wow, really?
It's gray area.
I didn't realize that
an unrefined fellow.
Yeah. I didn't know that Canuck who had such a potty mouth.
7:48 a.m., is she having an orgasm or decomposing?
Orgasming.
Really? Why can't you say, is she having an orgasm?
Because women shouldn't come. They're dirty.
Yeah.
That's why.
All right. All right.
Should cut off their clitorises and let them do their jobs under our bodies.
You're not trying to womb with teeth.
You're not doing the job here. First of all, you missed 7:44.
I know my glasses on.
Glasses on.
Blind ass.
All right, get your glasses on, because this is very entertaining for the folks.
When he
describes how the curse was used is the funniest part of this thing. Go to 7:44.
I'm sorry, I missed 7:44.
If the light hits his glasses and his hair, it bursts into flames. That's why you can't use them out in the sun.
You can only read with moonlight.
7:44, Mr. Louis C.K., somebody did me in the mouth during discussion of doctor who sexually assaulted and raped patients after they were knocked out.
Someone fucked my throat is what I meant to say.
Yeah, exactly.
I thought I cleaned it enough.
You might as well have just said that.
Can I say someone treated my mouth like a cunt? Is that
you know what, you might as well just let it fly, Louis.
Yeah.
So the XMers could enjoy it.
I guess so.
And then 7:48, Rich Voss. Is she having an orgasm or decomposing during a discussion of a story where somebody dug up a body and had sex with it?
That's a bad dump. That should not have been dumped.
Bad joke.
No, it is.
But I'm teasing, of course, Mr. Voss.
That should not have been dumped.
No.
It shouldn't have been dumped.
America needed to hear that on election morning.
Right.
The next day. This is a new era.
Exactly.
The Democrats have taken over. Was she
no
coming?
No more fear.
Or, yeah.
No more fear.
Maybe that'll be better for us, the Democrats take over.
No,
maybe.
It won't.
All right.
No, it won't.
It's not gonna,
Al Gore's cunty wife is the one who started all that labor.
Right. Yeah, that's right.
PMRC, man. Remember that? The big battle.
Cunty. She is.
Want to put labels on her albums, man. No. Yeah. Okay, shut up.
Where was she for the Ladybug song?
I know.
Oh,
hey, Rich.
Boy.
Very good. Right.
Uncle Rich's
nice
tickles.
Call back.
That's sleeping her
Rich's
fucking husband's withered switch.
I'm going to call Tucker Carlson, man. You're right there, man.
That's true.
Got to get you a spot on MSNBC.
Political humor.
Here's how you know Voice is about to say something dumb. Because his hands are stiff and he starts to use his hands. Rich, you use your hands when you get nervous. And his hands go out and his eyes open. Why, and you just know he's searching, and all he's saying is, please, God, let this come out right. I know what I mean. Please, God, let it come out right. His hands get stiff, and he just shakes them.
You can't tell if he's making a fist ever, either.
No.
You just don't know.
Bendless fingers.
It's just the same.
Like John McCain's arms.
Something happened.
Tiny.
Did you lose your hands in Vietnam? Yeah. What's going on there?
They replaced him with turtle feet.
Right. Something's going on there.
They are weird.
They're all weird.
I never noticed that.
The gargoyle hands.
The first night we were eating dinner, and then you lifted my hands, and you just stopped and go, look at your hands.
They're like not evolved.
Well,
that's exactly what it is.
There's one knuckle. He's one knuckle short of a human hand on each finger.
But they're all the same size, dude. Look at
his thumbs and his fucking middle fingers are the same.
Yeah, they're all the same size. So weird. Like everyone else, the middle one's a little longer, and then
I have if my kid drew his hands that way, I would fucking punch her. Learn how to draw, you stupid little cunt. What's wrong with you? You know how you draw a human hand? I've got what are you doing?
I've got web hands that aren't connected.
That's what it looks like.
And he's a great golfer. I don't get it.
Fucking beat her for that. All right, Kenny, continue.
Oh, that's fucking funny, man.
7:49 a.m., Louis C.K. again. Drink this homeless guy's urine.
You can't drink piss?
What's wrong with that?
I didn't say piss.
No.
No.
I used a clinical term.
Yeah.
Right. A minute later... 7:50, Louis C.K.
Jesus, sorry.
Touch their bodies with your penis.
All right, well, no, that...
We knew where that was going.
See, I knew it was
sacrificed that.
Yeah.
7:54, Dane Cook chimes in. We should all be molested by third and fourth graders.
That's not what it says there, Kenny. It's,
by
you
third
changed
or
the whole
grade.
Imagine being molested by a third or fourth grade.
I'm lucky it'd be.
You made it funnier, but the line was, we should all be molested by the third or fourth grade.
Oh, okay, that's different.
I thought it was a typo.
That's a CBS thing.
They have a problem with...
Any hot stuff.
Youngster stuff.
Yeah, kid stuff, they're like, no way.
Yeah, right. Well.
7:54 a.m., Rich Voss has a small penis.
I didn't say that.
Why can't you say that?
Facts are not allowed on the radio.
8 o'clock, Louis C.K. After Voss said 12 inches, you mean his penis?
Oh, my God. What baby's out? What? Ow, what are you doing? Is that an FCC thing?
Yeah, it's the FCC is tightened up, unfortunately.
8:20, I like this one from Louis C.K., little girl vagina smell.
Yeah. But that was, you were describing that as a father, describing a stinky daughter.
And smelly vagina of my daughter.
I desperately want to ask a lot of questions about that.
Yeah?
I've never heard that from a parent before, that you could smell.
No parent would say it.
They're
only
fucking liars. They're just liars.
But you can tell the difference between the ass smell and that smell at that age.
Any person. Wow. Fucking vaginas have a distinctive odor. If it's her ass, she's gonna die soon. Her fucking ass smells like fucking rotted clams.
Did you have a clue?
I had no clue.
Not having any children or knowing any people with girls that I would be around while they're dirty.
Mm-hmm.
No.
I figured it smelled like powder and shit. I didn't know what kids.
I figured every kid smells good.
I thought it smelled
when you have kids. As a guy, your relationship to the vagina, it just changes completely.
Really,
it's always this mysterious, beautiful little pouty thing that I only catch in glimpses in the dark, maybe 3 times in 40 years. And now I got to clean shit out of 2 of them daily. I have to literally scrape shit out of my daughter's little red vagina a few times a day.
Oh my God.
Gotta get in there with the wipey, make a corner out of it, and get the shit out of it. Every time she takes a shit, it goes straight up her gun.
God, I had no idea.
It's true.
The parents out there are all nodding. Wow.
They're all going, yep.
I had no clue.
The 4-year old doesn't she is toilet trained, but she'll lay on the carpet spreading it out, like pulling it open like a fucking hustler, like Marilyn Chambers, like fucking yanking it open and just going, man, like just lay there doing that.
Why?
Because that's what people want to do. I mean, that's the happiest I've ever seen any person, is her laying on the floor pulling her vagina open for the world. And I look at her and I realize that's a human being. That's a human being being happy. And for some reason, that's not okay. And wow. I have to, like, inhibit that so she won't be homeless.
What
do you mean, homeless? Everyone will put her up.
She continues doing that. She's going to be in a mansion somewhere.
What do you do? Because that's got to be one of those awkward things where you don't want to put too much emphasis it's on. It's
no,
like
you can't
freeze.
Go stop that.
Stop that, filthy, you animal. But you have to tell her that that's not right. So what do you...
You have to explain to her calmly that vaginas, when held wide open, hurt people's feelings.
Or, no, yeah. Or you bring your wife in and go, why don't you start doing it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, no, you just let her do it. Yeah, I have no reason to stop her right now.
Yeah,
people don't come over that often. But she will, like, she'll reach in her cute little girl underwear and scratch her asshole, like, a knuckle deep. Stick her finger in her ass in front of people and then smells her finger. She does that with no reserve.
Holy shit.
Norton still does that.
What the hell?
Yeah.
My ex-girlfriend used to do that. One time I caught her.
Oh.
She was sitting on her ass, and her legs were up, and she was sniffing her asshole with her finger. I'm like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Ew.
What are you doing?
No, like I had this moment with my, that's what it is really like. Parents dress their kids up and bring them out in public so that we can all see how cute they are, but at home it's just fucking disgusting. I was taking a shit the other day, and my wife was out of the house, so I have to shit with the door open. Because I have to watch my kids. Otherwise, I have to gather them in to watch daddy's shit. That's the only alternative. So I'm shitting with the door open and watching my daughter, who's standing there in a t-shirt and no diaper. Occasionally, we want to let her vagina breathe and not have all these American fucking products on it. And she's watching her from behind, and just a little dark spot just appears between her cheeks. And I didn't, honestly, for a second, I didn't realize what it was, because I've never just seen an ass shitting in the open. I know Jim has paid well for that.
Jesus, yeah, you missed
that pleasure. And then next thing I know, a fucking man-sized crap just fucking right. She shits on the floor, and then she slips on. Keep in mind, I'm shitting at the moment. She slips on her own shit, falls deeply into it, cracks her head. And now she's laying in her own shit and crying her eyes out because she got hurt. And I, with shit hanging out of my ass, I got to get up and waddle over. I got to do the penguin walk over and pick her up and comfort her. And we're both covered in my shit, her shit. The dog is trying to lick it up because the dog loves my daughter's shit. He tries to eat
and now,
it.
And
what
all
a that's fucking what madhouse!
Yes, that's my house.
And they're speaking German.
Until the tape's rolling.
But this is the stuff that happens.
This is a regular day. That is why I will never, ever take food from a child. I don't children touch. So it's, a cookie. You brought me a cookie. And they're like slobbering over half of it. And someone in the house, though, will eat this fucking piece of mucusy, spitty, shitty cookie. I'm looking like, don't even get that kid fucking near me.
No.
I threw away a couch because we had family. We had family come over. And two little boys sitting on the couch with their father watching television. And the father goes, what did you just do? And I'm sitting on the couch like, oh Christ on a pony, what the fuck? And he goes, nothing. And the father goes, no, did you pick your nose? And the kid starts kind of laughing, yeah. You wiped it on the couch. He goes, yeah, it fell. He goes, well, now we got to look for it. So they're foraging through my modular couch for a booger that they never fucking found.
No, of course not.
I then spent weeks sitting in a little shit chair. I have this beautiful couch sitting in a shit chair until a new couch is delivered and the old one was thrown away. Yeah. And the old, by old, I mean maybe 2 years old. Threw that fucking couch away and made a new rule, no kids ever in my fucking house.
No, keep them out.
That's it.
They're rancid little creeps.
My girlfriend had to go around like waist high with Windex and everything else, every other kind of cleaner on the walls because there's smear marks, nose prints made of snot on the sliding glass doors, little handprints like the end of fucking Blair Witch Project all over your walls. Mm-hmm. I was like, that's it.
No, the most disgusting thing that happens is when we change the baby's diaper and it's a big, just shit-pissed diaper. And then the dog, if we don't throw it away immediately in a sealed container, the dog will find it and just fucking eat it and leave the residue all over the floor. Oh, fucking chewed up shit piss diaper.
How
and the chemicals from the diaper.
How do you live like that?
It's fucking rotten.
How do you fucking live like that as a human?
Just regretfully.
I know, right?
Regretfully. With a huge amount of regret.
I thought this would be a cool thing, having
kids.
No, hey, you hit a nerve there, Louie. Let's go to John in Jersey. Kenny, we'll get to you in a second. John, what's up?
Hey, what's up, boys? What's going on? First of all, I have a contest idea, if you'd like to run with it. ONA nursery rhymes.
What?
Okay.
ONA type of nursery rhymes.
We heard you the first time.
For my daughter, like Jimmy with a transvestite. All right, crash me.
He knew he sucked.
What else, John?
Well, I wanted to say, though, I can totally relate with you about the vagina issue, because I've wiped shit out of my daughter's vagina numerous times. Mm-hmm. She's four, and I still have to get in there once in a while to fucking, you know, when she craps herself with these 8-inch freaking long logs.
That's what you're telling your wife?
That's the thing, is you got to, if your father, you should change diapers from the beginning. That's the trick. Because when you first get diapers, they have the meconium, which isn't really shit. It's just this black sludge that comes out of their ass when they're first born.
Sludge.
Yeah. And then it starts getting a little fetid.
Yeah.
You work up to it.
You start mixing some other ingredients in there, right?
Because I went on the road for a while, and I went away from it, and my daughter kind of turned the corner on me, and then I come back, I'm just, it's a guy's shit. After a while, it's just a big fucking dumperoo.
Oh, my God.
And you got to clean it.
Well, that is the last brown thing you want to see in your daughter's vagina.
I guess it could be worse.
That's killing today. And you're killing. All right. So, Kenny,
awful.
Doesn't it just sound horrific?
It just sounds horrid.
I remember when Jim and I were working on my show, and once we're about to start shooting, and he's eating in the scene. So I touch his food with my all over the place with my hands because I know he has to eat it professionally.
And he goes, "Are you kidding me? I pay women to shit in my mouth. You think I care?"
Yeah, touch away, Lou. I laugh at your fingers.
That was the funnest thing with Jim, was before we were whispering to each other before shooting. Anything disgusting I would say to him, he would top it.
Oh, yeah.
One time I said to him, "You know that AIDS started in your mother's ass." And he goes, "Yeah, well, it's going to end there, too." And then the bell rings. We're back. Right.
I remember one time, one of my favorite things was we were doing a scene in the it was me, him, and Mike in the bar area, the little diner we were sitting in. And there was a chick playing a waitress in the day before shoot, and someone bought her a shirt. And you know, like the clear plastic long strip on it that will say like
the Gap large, yeah, that.
Uh huh.
It would just say like a bunch of L's on it for a large.
Yeah.
She had it on her thing, and he said,
on
her tit, and she didn't know it was there. And he said, "All I want is for that to be there tomorrow when we shoot."
Yeah. Nobody catches that.
Please let nobody catch that. Just for her to shoot that stupid plastic clear thing on her.
Have you ever walked out of the house with one of those?
Oh my God! On my pants, clothes? Yeah.
Yeah, on the back leg of your pants.
Sure. Absolutely.
Like you
walked out of department stores with that on.
All right, back to Kenny. The dump report. Where were we?
8:24 a.m. On his knees, pleasuring someone for a vial. Anthony, about Voss needing money for drugs, on his knees, gave it too much detail.
Oh, it did not.
Come on, Al.
That's really touchy.
Yeah.
I would love to see the station be fined for that. It just wouldn't happen. Mm. I've read transcripts of what the stations get fined for. It's a lot more blatant than that. Stop.
Wait, hold on. Yeah, I hear that, too.
What is that?
It might be the wireless.
Oh, I thought it was music. Oh. Okay.
All right, go ahead, Kenny.
8:40 a.m. You can see that stuff in your underwear. Voss talking about Norton and his STD test for syphilis and gonorrhea and how you know if you have it.
Yeah, let's get into this. Because as soon as you said that, I knew they were going to dump out. I'm like, come on, we got to discuss this a little bit. But what do you see in your underwear?
No, when you have the clap or syphilis, you get a green drip in your underwear.
Oh, green.
You know what?
Drip.
I'm glad they dumped that.
Holy fuck.
Well, I'm saying you could see it. You know that you have the clap. That's why you go. It burns or you have a discharge.
It's an infection.
Yeah. What? Stuff pours out.
Yeah, let's hear that one again.
Discharge.
Discharge.
So,
it's green?
I guess, I don't know. When I
know you
I
know.
Heard.
You all too well know.
Yeah, and it was in the back.
Olive green.
Yeah, it's horrible. You burn. And
you about the clap?
Did I have it?
Yeah.
Oh, please, when I was like 17, 18, back then
he didn't at the clap.
You didn't have condoms back then.
He's the one that named it.
He's the one who coined the phrase.
No, you didn't. used to go to the clinic, and you'd know people there. Oh, you're back again, and this and that.
His underwear
looked
like a mesh
so much that they'd applaud him when he. That's how they started calling him the clap.
Yeah, Rich is back.
Hey, Rich, back. Nice to see you again.
The worst was making a boo for a while. The worst was I lived with this girl, and she was going down on me, and I had the crabs, and all of a sudden she sees this little crab moving, and she's going down on me, and she flipped out. I go, well, you're not going to finish. I mean, you started. Just get rid of, you know, you're flinging off. And those are the worst.
fling it off.
Yeah, what's the big deal? It's a crab, okay? So you just get rid of it. You know, you can't start giving someone head and stop.
Yes, no. You can. I've had crab three times. Yes, you can.
You had crabs?
Yeah.
I had crabs once. Yeah, that was pretty awful.
Three times.
Wow.
Pretty awful.
God
damn. Scabies are worse because they burrow in the skin.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kenny. They burrow in.
Actually, when I got the crabs, a girl that I had just slept with called me and said, hey, you have the crabs, you asshole. And I was like, what? And she said, I just realized I have the crabs, which means you gave them to me. I'm like, fuck you, you gave me. We got
fighting out of the crabs. Ever settled? And you
know,
you probably knew.
I hadn't slept with anybody recently, so I don't know where I got them.
Well, the crabs is not like VD or the clam or anything. You can get it from a toilet seat.
No one ever has, though.
You know something? Yeah. I've never gotten it from a bed or a toilet seat. I've never gotten it.
Well, obviously, you never jerked off on a toilet seat before then.
Yeah.
You
can, obviously,
as a kid? As a kid, I jerked off on everything. Everything.
You can get it from a bed. You can get it from a bed in a hotel.
You can also get it from a girl or a prostitute.
Right. Mm-hmm. Maybe you ought to look. Did you ever get it from a bed?
Did I?
Yeah.
This was years. I don't remember where I didn't.
All right.
I'll tell you where I got it from. A 19-year-old. No, she was. I was 19. She was like 16 or 15. Black girl. And her pussy smelled so bad, I could smell it. We were sitting on my steps, and she was standing two steps away, and I could smell her pussy through her jeans.
I know.
It was like she was smuggling a platypus carcass in her underpants. It fucking reeked.
I was fucking this girl. Her pussy was so bad. I had to lean over the side of the bed, and I was dry heaving. I'm not lying. Her pussy smelled. I was dry heaving as I'm fucking her. Right?
Oh, and thank
God.
Though.
Well, thank God that I'm a bad fucking. I would come quick. I killed two birds with one stone. It was so bad, that fucking horrendous smell.
Here's the worst. When you pull your dick out and it reeks, and there's that fucking white slime on the base of your dick.
That's
a yeast infection.
Whatever
it
is, who knows? That's probably why it reeks, too. Yeast fucking kills a box.
Yeah.
When you fucking got that in your pubes, that fucking white caked up
haste.
Shit. Like fucking Betty Crocker.
I was
your vanilla dumper.
I picked up this fucking Mexican, and I was working Houston, and it was disgusting. I'm fucking a little... Then she leaves, and I look in the bed, and there's a wrapped-up napkin that she was using. It's a fucking Kotex. I didn't know she was...
She had just wrapped a napkin, used that, and
I guess somewhere in a club, she put a napkin wrapped up as a Kotex. And I felt disgusting just from fucking her. And then I roll over, and I roll onto this bloody napkin.
Oh, God.
Did you put it in your mouth and suck on it?
No.
How bad that would have smelled.
Little bloody burrito.
Like pennies.
What a history you have. And then you're mad at some girl for not wanting to blow you while there was a crab in your...
Crab with wine in her eyeball.
So you have wildlife in your pubes. There's fucking an elk on your balls, and you want to know why she wants to suck your cock. Selfish asshole.
All right, let's finish up the dump
report.
There's
more. Wow.
Yeah.
841, Louis C.K. When you're done masturbating to FHM.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't. They hate masturbating, that word. Yeah.
They're such babies.
I know.
Say, you gotta say stroke the baby producer.
And that's not even an FCC word either, masturbate.
Speaking of FHM, they should get the monthly issue with you guys in it.
Oh, thank you, Kenny.
Good tie-in, Kenny.
Very nice. Good plug.
And behind-the-scenes photos on opiananthony.com.
Cool.
We finally got those up there. Go ahead.
8:44 a.m. Louis C.K. again. Your baby's being raped.
Ah, well.
Baby. Well,
you know. That's
my baby. Oh.
8:50 a.m. Mr. Norton, did the lamb make you perform fellatio? Did he sodomize you?
Oh, my God.
All right. No, that has to go.
Does it really?
Yeah, new FCC.
To make you perform fellatio? It's not even dirty.
I think all of it is ridiculous.
Yeah, absolutely. It's ridiculous, but...
It's meaningless.
Go ahead. Last one.
Last one, 8:50, from a caller. Why did you have sex when you were 10?
Oh, my...
That one is...
Another one of those. Too
kid
young.
Stuff. Kid stuff.
It wasn't talking in any detail about... whatever.
Well, this started fun, and now it's this sucks. All right, we'll continue. We got lots of other things to do today. We got some Dice audio.
Yeah. Oh, yeah?
Dice smashes one of the ONA pests at one of his shows.
One?
So now, that was half his crowd.
Well, we'll talk about that next. We got a reporter messing up and saying top cock. This is really funny.
Mm-hmm. Top cock?
Yeah, Louis C.K. in studio playing Vegas November 16th and 17th.
Yes.
Voss starting tomorrow night at Helium Comedy Club all weekend long in Philadelphia.
It's Whip 'em Out Wednesday.
It's not nude. It's just girls flashing guys that have WOW on their vehicle somewhere. That's the WOW campaign.
Wow.
For details on how to get your very own WOW sticker, go to opiananthony.com.
Look at that WOW. It's still happening.
Oh, it's the WOW.
It's Whip 'em Out Wednesday.
Opie, Anthony, Jim Norton, and the comedians of the Opie and Anthony Show are appearing in a special holiday edition of FHM on sale now.
Go ahead, Jimmy.
I like welcoming everyone back to the Opie and Anthony radio program here on XM Satellite Radio. Now we're only on XM Satellite Radio with Louis C.K. and Richard Voss and Ant Note, myself, and Hawk and Fan.
And Voss was brilliant when we went to break.
Wow.
Listening to Voss trying to make poignant statements, I want to hug him.
It was good stuff, Rich.
Thanks for listening. Yeah, see, he agrees. He knows. Yeah,
Rich said, he says really deep things, like it's about money. And then he opens his eyes wide, like conversation over.
The almighty dollar.
That's right. Hit them in their pocketbooks.
And seatbelts on buses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Somehow it went from the, you know, horrors of hijacking and why there weren't locks on cockpit doors to seatbelts on buses.
You know what it is? He saw some expose, like, last night and couldn't figure out a way to talk about it. And today he figured out a way. Like, it just happened that we went in that direction.
You know,
I thought he was making some sense. I don't know.
How was that?
I thought he was making sense.
Yeah, thank you. But see, here's the thing. You know, we're talking about hijacking an anthrax, and this idiot's opened a box from a stranger.
No,
you
here's the box. Like, it's not from a stranger.
Oh.
It's from Dirty Ralph. The guy's the greatest.
Oh, it's Dirty Ralph.
And Kiss CDs and DVDs.
Oh,
there's a friend of mine that I threw the show. He sends me good stuff. Thank you, Dirty Ralph.
But I do make a lot of sense. I do know.
You don't make sense.
Yes, I do.
No,
we're talking
don't.
About senators and lobbyists and making deals and who's running the country and who's, you know.
But you were saying it's
to.
A conspiracy.
Yeah.
Then you were just straightened out by everyone.
Louis talking about how big business is just kind of really runs our lives more than the
government.
Politicians do
right,
and the government, just based on the fact that they're the ones that supply us with everything we need on a daily basis to live as humans in this country.
Mm-hmm.
And you brought up a conspiracy.
No.
It's like no one thought 40, 50 years ago that it was going to be this was going to be the end game. It just capitalism evolved into this as like communism evolved into something that didn't quite work. Capitalism is evolving into this other thing where business has
a lot
of power.
The way that Halliburton supplies the soldiers, and so they charge whatever they want,
right?
And they fuck it all up, and nobody cares.
No,
it's
I'm
the same
saying,
thing. If you live in any town in America, you're getting your food from ShopRite and your crap from Walmart, and nobody else can even send a truck there.
And there's no accountability by these other people, that's just the way it is.
And what are you going to boycott? You're only one person.
Yeah.
What the author he was talking about is making it look like a conspiracy. What I'm saying is, it's all about money. He's not telling us anything we don't know. When you're talking about Noam Chomsky saying it's these big businesses.
Speaking of Noam, how are those hands doing?
I think they were open that time. I'm not sure.
Anyone else? Yeah, love you on the Travelocity commercials, boss.
Wow. All right, we got a news reporter that fucked up pretty good.
Oh,
oops.
No.
This is some terrific audio. The video's up on YouTube and Break.com.
Rich's headphones are not working. Turn the volume up, Rich.
I did.
Oh, Rich, you could do it without headphones.
Sweetie, but he won't hear the report up.
Calm
he won't
down.
Hear
That's
the audio.
True.
Oh, I see, yeah.
Got to hear that.
Somebody
turn the volume up. You plugged in?
I'm sure he's got something misspelled to say about this report. So.
Here we go.
The deputy police chief says six officers were killed, including the district's top cock after a cop after the hit.
Wow, twice.
Wow.
She couldn't get cock.
Hold on.
She had cock on a brain.
Cock.
I mean, big cock.
Cock.
Wow.
Is that great?
Wow.
The deputy police chief says six officers were killed, including the district's top cock, after a cop, after the vehicle they were riding in was sprayed with bullets. Three other officers were hurt in
bullets.
The attack. And those are your latest headlines. I'm Jane Skinner.
Head.
I'm going to send you back to Shepherd, who is live where? Just outside of Memphis.
Wow.
No honesty.
Oh. They're all laughing.
South Carolina Gamecocks. She's a big fan. Go South Carolina.
Do you know how hard it is to read when everyone else in the studio is shaking with laughter at your misfortune?
I know. I've been there, Jane.
You're for me.
Many billions of times.
Okay. I love that.
Wow. It's Friday, Jane. No one's watching. They're out doing things. It's just me, you, and Dorellen down in Destin. That's it. We'll look for you on YouTube there, Jane.
Thanks so much.
Oh, that's good.
Right,
I love that a policeman died and they're all laughing.
They're all laughing over cock.
Yeah.
Great.
Fuck them.
Who cares? YouTube.
Cop, faggot. Laid his life down for people. Fuck him.
Yeah, fuck him. We got the cock line on YouTube. Yeah. It's great. Watch this chick.
The deputy police chief says six officers were killed, including the district's top cock after the vehicle they were riding
in. You
can
hear him starting to laugh.
Yeah. Is that Otto doing the thing?
Top cock. A cock was shot.
Do we have the Shepard Smith one?
We have that, and we should do Rip Cunt for Louie and the Blackcock one.
Come on, let him rip.
Let's
Shepard Smith. This was Shepard Smith we got first. Yeah. This is the guy that was just talking to the girl after she fucked up saying top cock. This is the guy that chimed in and said, we've all been there. He's done this before.
J-Lo's new song, Jenny from the Block, all about Lopez roots, about how she's still a neighborhood gal at heart. But folks from that street in New York, the Bronx section, sound more likely to give her a curb job than a blow job or block party.
Oh,
the New York Post. Well, sorry about that slip up there.
Yes, sorry about that.
I have no idea how that happened, but it won't happen again. And that's your news.
That wasn't even close.
No, it wasn't.
Blow job.
fucking so, cop. You know, fucking dick in the cunt. I mean, breakfast.
J-Lo, like, what? J-Lo. New film, Rape That Spick. Wait a minute, that's not what I meant to say.
I meant made whatever.
Deputy police chief says six officers were killed, including the district's top cock. After the vehicle they were.
Jesus. You can't get cock off her.
One thing I'll say about dumb Shepard Smith, he did acknowledge it both times. You gotta give him that. He's a
You have to.
We acknowledge it.
We got this next one. We haven't played in a while.
Easterly winds will be very strong, too, and that will cause coastal flooding, very dangerous rip currents, as well as very high surf.
Wow.
Rip currents.
Do we have the...
I like the idea that there's weather about? That's ripped, like there's going to be these cunts ripping through the sky.
I was going to say, was she talking about Louis's daughter?
Do you have the Tom Brokaw?
The Brokaw one we have?
Oh, we got that one, too?
How about the Martin Luther King
one? That's a good one, too.
Yeah, we'll play the other one there.
Play Brokaw, because that's kind of close to the last one.
Or play the one you got, Derek. He had one. All
right.
Make it easy for him.
Continuing to follow the latest developments in the crash of Delta Flight 5191, 49 people killed. Here's a Black Hawk helicopter surveying the scene. We know the NTSB.
Black Cock helicopter.
This is the latest. This is the latest rage on YouTube. I mean, there's all dedicated to reporters fucking up.
Plane full of dead people.
Black Cock. Funny. Funny Black Cock.
The Black Hawk helicopter. How big was that helicopter?
Oh. Now this Tom Brokaw.
The
bell.
Oh.
Thank you.
There we go. Close one.
I had a doozy.
A little inappropriateness. This is Tom Brokaw, who has a hard enough time speaking as it is. But he was talking about the president's tax cuts, and this was live.
The key component in what the president insists is a job stimulus program. Ohio, a strong Republican state, is hurting economically. And as NBC David Gregory reports tonight, the president took his message right to a powerful Ohio Republican who is not convinced the tax cuts are the answer.
See, he didn't fumble and go back.
Now, there's a little delay. The tax cuts are the answer. And his face, when you look at the video, is kind of like, oh, shit. Keep going. Keep going.
You know, as a viewer, though, you're rooting for him to get to the end of the sentence.
Tax cuts.
He's just struggling to that period.
Oh.
All right, we got the Martin Luther one.
Yeah, this guy got fired for this.
Of course, it's crazy. None of them got fired except this guy did because of the this is what annoyed
and
me.
And this is obviously a slip-up, I think.
Of course it was.
Yeah, let's listen to it, and then we'll tell you what he meant to say.
the next couple of days, temperature is going to stay well above normal after a couple of days well below normal. Here's a look at your extended forecast for tomorrow. Sunshine, 60 degrees, Martin Luther King Jr. Day. We're going to see temperatures in the low 60s and mostly sunny skies. Look at that as we head toward Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday.
It was King...
Because he was going with Junior. It was Junior. Martin, that's Martin Luther King Jr. It wasn't
King Jr. Yeah, King Jr. He was like
rushing through it.
King Jr. comes out, Coon.
Black Hawk helicopter isn't fired.
Black Hawk.
A cop death.
And rip cunt.
Rip cunt.
Tax cunt.
Top cock over a police officer. Six dead cops. And then no one let him fire, but this guy makes a politically incorrect, obvious error, and they dump him.
Mm. Oh, can we do the, do you have the mountain climber one? That is my favorite. I forgot all about that one. Oh, we do have it?
Yeah. I don't know that one.
So many of these.
One, Louis.
Okay. Right after the break, we're going to interview Eric Weihenmayer, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. I mean, he's gay. Excuse me. He's blind. So we'll see about that.
But he's gay. He's gay.
You know, there's some gossip you heard at lunch.
Oh, he's blind.
She went to lunch with the girls and got some nice gossip. And that's all she was thinking.
And even she went, he's gay. Gay.
Right.
I mean, fucking blind. Shit.
No.
He takes a dick up his ass. Wait a minute.
He has brown eyes. I don't know how I made that assumption.
He's so blind that people shove dicks in his mouth. It made him gay.
It's he just can't see them coming.
But he was everywhere he goes, he's like,
he's gay. You know, the guy's sitting there going, and I'm,
but listen to gay. Because she starts talking to herself like, gay?
Gay,
like,
what are you saying?
I said that.
Who said that?
Yeah, let's hear that again.
It's me.
Right after the break, we're going to interview Eric Weihenmayer, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. I mean, he's gay. Excuse me. He's blind. So we'll hear about that coming
up. Okay. As we head to the break, I'll look at this.
They're not even close.
No.
There's not one letter that is shared by both words.
No. Gay, blind, no.
He's a faggot cocksucker. Wait, I mean, he's a Republican.
Got a load of cum in both eyes, which blinded him.
God, we got a lot of requests. You got the weatherman?
Which one was that?
The black weatherman? I don't want to give away the...
Yeah, don't give away the punchline.
The bit, in case people haven't heard
it. Uh-oh, E-Rock's pointing at the screen. You know this isn't going to be the right clip.
Do you see the look?
Yeah. I
wish this was TV just to see E-Rock's disgusted look when I make fun of him.
Oh, he hates it.
Turns his head real quick like, it's such a fuck you. And then he's back to... Whatever he does.
Yeah, exactly. Back to the incompetent bungling.
We got it? I guess.
They hope so.
All right, here it is.
Be pushing across Central Florida, so places like Orlando, Daytona Beach, the Cape Canaveral area, Vero Beach will be getting in on the heavier rainfall, and eventually that should... I am so sorry, Bill. Oh, my God!
What the fuck?
This is what just happened. That thing was crawling on my leg.
Oh. By the way, that guy is so fucking blind.
He is the blindest
man I've ever seen. That is a flaming blind man.
That guy's gay voice came out.
That fella needs a dog and a stick with red on it.
Like, he was hiding his gay voice for the most part. You could kind of tell. And then it's a cockroach. The cockroach appears.
Well, a roach. I think the other kind he would have liked.
And the Janus came flying out of the closet.
Oh,
we got another track to this, right? And then this happened.
Oh, God. Oh, my God!
What a faggot.
Right at the wall for me.
The wall with a hole in it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, what a fruit. Jesus, it's a bug.
Yeah, I know, and he's black, like he's never seen roaches.
Oh,
I love when you see, like, when there's this kind of people that can't really hide, like that guy, the preacher, who's just been accused.
Yeah. Oh,
and I had never seen the whole story. And it's you know, they discredit the gay prostitute, saying, well, he, you know, lie detector. But then they cut to the guy, I'm not gay at all, and my wife, I love my wife.
This is fine. He's so flaming. And that guy had to really pop right out and go, okay, I'm a liar.
How great.
I do drugs, and I like the cock.
How great.
Thank you, good night. Thank you, my parish.
All these fucking scumbag religious people fucking just bothering gay people.
The only reason the guy came out against them was because this fucking guy was up there preaching against gay marriage and homosexuality is the devil's fucking work. And and this guy is fucking him every month, turns around and goes, you know something? Fuck you.
Good for that guy.
No, yeah.
It's amazing. It's like the whole point, especially, this guy's not Catholic, but I'll shit on them for it anyway.
Why not?
But, because, doesn't matter what I say. I'm not a politician.
Yeah, right?
I'm not going to have bad judgment. I'm just trying to be entertaining. Exactly. No, but it's like, if you look at the Catholic Church objectively, it's like they are a boy-fucking machine. They're like the best boy-fuckers in history. It's almost the whole point of the institution. It's like what they do that better than anything else that they have tried.
They've worked it into an art.
It's amazing. They move guys around when they get caught.
They move them around. They have their own internal investigations, so it doesn't involve anyone else. Mm-hmm. They made their own almost police force of this thing. Mm-hmm. And all they do is, yeah, okay, this guy's fucking touching children here. We'll move him over here.
Yeah. And
like
also, they're a vulnerable boy catching machine.
Oh, yeah.
You parents
send them. Exactly. Their parents send them. Fucking, here you go.
Go get your dick
rape
sucked.
Away.
Moving back for a second, Bert and Philly on the instant feedback. His last name is Haggard, just like his asshole.
Yeah, fucking Pastor Ted was a naughty one.
Yes,
Pastor Ted was a naughty boy.
Naughty boy.
We got any others back there?
Mike Jones was giving him some muscle dick.
Do we have the one with the argument?
The argument.
I love the one that happened during Katrina.
What?
I think it was during Katrina, weatherman for CNN, and the anchor girl.
Okay, that's a good one.
The weatherman was taking a little too long.
I don't remember that one.
We might as well play all of them then, because we got to play the LA news team. That is a great one.
Another good one.
And Derek's got one here to play.
Because they're such puppets. I mean, when they fuck up, it's great.
You simply get chills every time you see these poor individuals. As Jack Cafferty just pointed out, so tragically, so many of these people, almost all of them that we see, are so poor and they are so black. And this is going to raise lots of questions for people who are watching this story unfold.
Wolf Blitzer, man.
Yeah, right on.
I watched
Wolf
that
Blitzer
live.
Said that?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
I watched that live when it happened. I'm just sitting watching Katrina coverage because it's all you did when that was going on. I went home, turned on the news.
Yeah, it's better than Comedy Central.
It really was. Just a scream. And Wolf Blitzer's on. He's in front of his 20,000 TV screens. And when he said that, I actually looked over at my girlfriend and said, did he just say that?
America said the same thing.
Yeah.
So if you'd been standing anywhere, you would have heard that.
They are so poor and so black.
But where was he going with that? I don't get, was it their tone?
I think it was trying to go into the fact that, you know, they're not getting the help they need because of their race.
Right.
Yeah, if it was a bunch of white people. But to say they're so poor and so black.
And he's stunned by people's blackness.
You could say that about three
Jesus,
people.
Those
you know?
Fuckers are black.
Two people in the room. They are so black. Yeah. I think he meant there are so many that are so poor. And so many black people, but he fucked it all up just going, there's one guy that is just black as night.
Well, you can't blame him. It's not like he's an eminent journalist or anything.
No.
It's not like that.
Hasn't
his
been
job.
In the business that many years.
Yeah.
We got another one. We got two more to play here.
But the storm was 902 millibars. 902 was the lowest that you had with this storm a couple of hours ago. So it has filled in a little bit, filled in with some air, let me talk, Carol.
Translate that for us. I don't know what that means. What does that mean?
Well, if you would let me talk.
Okay.
Camille was 908. And so this is actually now not as strong as Camille, but not really as strong as it's been. 908, I'm walking over here because I can have this chart, but it's not in front of me. 908 millibars is 26.81 inches of mercury. This storm got down to 26.61, and right now it's 26.98. Now, if you would go to your home barometer that you have, it's probably a big circle hanging on your wall that you got from an uncle somewhere. If you go look at that, that is completely off the screen.
This guy got something from an uncle,
rarely,
and it wasn't a barometer.
You have to have a barometer that would go that low in the northern hemisphere, unless you were up
to... Shut up!
get under her.
Who cares?
Thank
she
you, was. All right, just having fun.
She nailed it.
Just having fun, he says. He goes, all right, just having fun. No, it wasn't fun. You were angry. She had every right to fucking jump in because he's babbling about barometric fucking pressure.
That guy's an asshole.
Oh, what a tool.
I don't know who he is, but if you live in his town, please invite him to die on purpose. Please fucking encourage him.
I don't know that man, but he's a cunt.
What How many more douche. We got? Just the L.A.?
All right, and then we finally got this. I don't think this made the air, Louis, but I guess...
During a break.
During a break, the news team went at it. It's like a chick and a guy there in L.A. And they just went at it just before the news started. Listen to this tape.
First segment.
It's done that way all the time.
It frequently is.
Well, then we better talk about it.
Do you hear me complaining about it?
Then we better
tonight
talk about
I'm
it.
Tonight I'm complaining because tonight
then
I said
Then we better
hey.
Talk about it because I think
I agree.
You've got a problem. I think we've got a problem, all right? If that's what you think, then we'll talk about it after the show, and we'll talk about it with Roger Bell. Because I'm not going to sit here night after night and put up with this shit. Okay?
Night after night? Night after night?
Well, it looks to me like that's the way it's going to go,
I'll take the ante up a little higher than that, even.
Than that, even.
You're not only wrong, you're way out of line.
Let me tell you something.
You started it, pal.
You want Harold Green, you might get him.
Fine with me. Good old Harold Green.
Okay. Okay. You want to start dealing with shit? Go ahead. That's what you want. You just might get it.
Awesome.
You know, you go home and have a couple of shooters, and I don't know what the fuck happens, but when you come back, you're not the same lady.
That's not true.
Some nights it is, man.
When news happens, you see it happen on Channel 7.
Don't you?
The number one station for news and information in Southern California. Now, Paul Moyer and Martin, Johnny Mountain Weather, and Todd Donahoe Sports. This is Eyewitness News Tonight.
Three men dead tonight in an execution-style murder in Los Angeles.
And he just goes right into it, man. What a pro. What a fucking pro. Accusing his fucking lackey next to him of drinking when she goes home. Do a few shooters. I don't know who the fuck you come back at.
In between the 6 and 11 o'clock news.
Yeah, I'll tell you something, lady.
They go home and do whatever.
You're a different lady.
You're a different lady.
Oh,
do a couple
awesome.
Of fucking shooters. And she's just, I do not. In a tone of voice that means, yes, I do every fucking night to deal with you.
We got one more. We keep finding them. The Bill Evans and Steve Bartlestein fight over Donald Trump's wife's name.
Yeah.
Seen this?
Mm-hmm.
This is the new dress. It's something old, something
The weatherman
new.
Is taunting the anchor guy. Yeah, it's the anchor says her name wrong, and the weatherman starts taunting him, and he gets pissed. Like, what? You're the fucking weatherman.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you taunting me, motherfucker?
Have you seen this?
Mm-hmm.
This is the new dress. It's something old, something new, and something that costs about $100,000. Here's a look at the wedding dress made for supermodel Melania Knauss, the former or the future Miss.
Wait, go over that name again, Steve. What was that?
You know what? Why don't you do it, Bill?
No, I'm not the anchor, Steve.
Melania, right?
Why don't you go over it? Why don't you do it?
I'm not the anchor.
Well, you know what? Then I'll pipe down over there during the VO.
Well,
wouldn't you?
What then, Steve?
Go ahead, do it, Bill.
It has 300 feet of satin.
If you're not the anchor, then don't interrupt me.
I wanted to know
now,
what
if
you
you're
said.
Not the anchor, then
go,
don't...
Go, baby, go. Go.
The gown was designed by John Galliano for Christian Dior. And the bride plans another dress of Vera Wang design after the couple's first dance. Wedding is set for Saturday. Why don't you give it a shot there, Bill?
Hey, I'm just representing the audience.
I heard
Moonlight and now.
My bad. I'm sorry, Bill.
I'm not looking for an apology, Steve.
I know, so
I'm just saying,
sorry.
Would you like to take another shot?
No, I wouldn't.
I can't take a shot at it. That's why I do the weather. I don't read that stuff.
Right. It is so cold
it is
outside.
It's cold in here, too.
Take a shot at the weather if you want.
I don't
matter.
I'm good with that.
Hey, dude, I'm...
Okay.
I get paid either way.
It's
the weather to start the day. And it will be a day where it will be a cold day.
We looked out and got that one on our own. We just happened to be rolling.
We were watching that as it happened.
No one has that one. That one never made it to
local,
YouTube or anything.
No, local people get in each other's asses.
Oh,
they really do.
Yeah.
Sometimes when I do stand-up on the road, I do, like, some TV morning show.
Mm-hmm.
as if anybody that's watching morning TV is going to.
Those are the worst.
But it was this one in Sacramento, and it was the usual team, kind of older guy and lady with too much makeup. But they had put in a young guy, like hoping that was going to beef up, you know, that's going to bring in the younger
demo. Get the ladies to watch
it. Some fucking guy who had a show on Comedy Central for a minute. I forget his name. Chris something. I forget his name.
Colin Quinn?
But so he, I said, hey, he said, yeah, I'm stuck here in Sacramento doing local news. What a shitty job, you know, but during the break.
Oh.
And I said, sitting right next to him is the anchor who's been there for like 50 years. And I said to the guy, to the young guy, you know, it's a job. You should be grateful that you're working. There's nothing wrong with local news. It's a career. And the old anchor goes, yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Yes.
Oh,
Could you listen to him, please?
Like,
and they got into
serious?
A huge yelling match.
Oh,
and then we're on the air in a second. Hi, good morning.
Hey, how you doing, everybody? Spread the love. We love each other. I love it.
We've had some of those around here. Are we kidding?
Oh, yeah. Why don't you play the Jim Norton Opie one?
That was on the air, though. We didn't hide that. That was done
on the air.
Yeah,
no shit.
That was on the air, man.
For an hour.
Unfortunately. Really? And I was that. Did you hear how that whole, that fucking bitch during that last segment was sitting there trying? She goes, well, boys, now. Get. That was me. I fucking grew tits and my cock turned into a pussy in a second when these two started going at it.
We went at it and we honestly thought it was like 5 minutes. Seriously, maybe 7 minutes. Someone goes, dude, you guys just went at it for 15 minutes.
It was 15 minutes where...
I can't imagine that.
This wasn't a fucking joke. It wasn't a bit. I mean, serious. Listen to me, fuckface.
I can't
like,
imagine
that kind
that.
Of shit. And I, all of a sudden, I was 7 years old, and my mommy and daddy were arguing,
That's
and
awful.
The spaghetti hit the wall and went down the wall, and I was watching it. My father threw the spaghetti, and I saw the sauce going down the wall. Same feeling. I was like, stop it, stop.
Were you uncomfortable?
Oh. All I think I said was something like, what did I say? Holy shit. Or I just went, oh, fuck, or whatever. It was like Spinal Tap, where the two guys are arguing in the studio, and then the bass player and the drummer are in the behind the glass booth, and they just go, this is all we fucking need. Like, they have no input on it and can't stop it.
No.
That was me.
It was just like two brothers fighting, though, because everyone's like, then there was all sorts of discussions like, that's the end of the show. This is it. This is going to break them all up. And me and Jim talked, and it was like, it took 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Even though we fought for almost an hour, it was 10 seconds. Well,
you got it out.
I'm sorry, too. And that
you
was
got it. Out.
It's so fucked up because it started during a break, and then we go back live, and to just do the show. You can do it, but at that point, it was impossible for these two.
But it's also, it would have been so phony and forced.
Yeah.
It's like, look, we're not the most perfectly honest people. We're fairly honest about what's going on.
We try to be as honest. We try to be more honest than anyone else doing this dumb job.
It would have been a lie to have not just ignored. It just bled into the thing.
Well, there's a degree of what's going on during breaks or before the show that you can then be... a professional, you know, technically a professional and get in and do your job. Then if it passes that point, you are incapable of sitting and looking at that person and fucking, so let's do the story on the fucking chick that went to the strip club. And it, you know, you just look and go, hey, motherfucker, you know, you want to fucking punch you.
There are guys that can do that, though. There are guys that can fight like that and go right back into it. Yep.
Hey, how you doing?
That's why those shows are awful.
Well, yeah, those are one market sensations. The best part of the fight, in the middle of it, all of a sudden Ant just went, holy shit.
Yeah, I just went, holy shit.
Holy shit.
Well, you were alone in here.
It was done. It was pretty much just, like, I was, at the beginning, I tried mediating something a little like, guys, not during the show, let's, you know.
Right.
It's like, you know, this fucking guy, this shit. And it's like, all right, I'll step back.
I've been doing the show with Anthony for 12 years. I think that was the first and only time I didn't even notice he was in the room. I had no clue.
Yeah.
No clue he was
these
here.
These two were.
No, at one point, not even, no clue that we were even broadcasting the thing.
And the way the fight went, it was, your two tactics, it was like watching Ultimate Fighting, where one's a grappler and one's just a fighter, because Opie was the in-your-face, go fuck your mother, fuck you guy, and Jimmy is the, oh,
Yeah, really, really, really. Well, why don't you tell me, like I'm going to get him with intellect and sarcasm and passive aggressive, and to watch the two styles was really cool.
Wow. I know, because the bulldog, which would have been Opie.
Yep.
I don't know. Jimmy rushes was pretty tough, man.
You know, and then Jimmy would be the guy that steps aside.
Right, and steps to the side, lets him pass the gun. So, what were you working on there?
Which works for a while, but eventually the guy's going to catch you and he's going to kick your ass.
Jimmy worked me so bad, I've never wanted to strangle someone so bad in my life.
Oh, no, I know. You wanted to kill him.
I want to strangle this guy.
Oh, really? Oh, it's just, oh, really? Oh, why don't you tell me about it? Why don't you, like, turning everything around
The worst thing you can do is use somebody's words against them in an argument. Oh, yeah. Nobody likes that.
No one likes that, you tool.
Awful.
I love it.
Awful.
And then stupid XM decided not to rerun the thing. That wasn't our decision.
No, it was not our decision.
Did we ever talk about what happened after the fight?
I don't even remember.
See, Jimmy
ELO was freaking out.
Oh, no, not that. I mean, during the show. Like, after that fight went on, then we went on with the show and I think I just talked to you, and then Jimmy just talked to you. And Jimmy and I always leak together. Like, we have to leak every break. Yeah. Every break. And we usually are side by side, right? So, you know, I got a leak. Aww. He's got a leak. And, you know, I have to leak no matter what. So we walk into the bathroom. Slam. The door slams. And then I go in. Slam. And then he goes into a stall. Slam. And then I go into a stall. Slam. We're just, like, talking by not talking. Like, Jesus, you motherfucker. Christ. And we usually, like, just piss next to each other and have just a little
chit-chat at the urinal.
A little show chat.
Right. And then he's done with the stall. Slam. I'm done. Slam. Out the door. Slam. Slam. Oh, it was hilarious. Wow. We had to do that for the rest of the show.
It was. Oof. I remember Brandon Iron came in with a chick, and we were watching porn, and that kind of helped us because we had something to focus on that wasn't...
All right.
So we were watching porn on the TV and kind of describing the porn we were watching, which helped a little bit because it was something outside.
Yeah,
of what
great
we
radio.
When we were talking, we were talking, but doing what we could after that. I mean, it was
sacrifice whatever's going out over the radio to just try to make peace in here.
Yeah.
Put on porno and let's describe and it. Describe
that
it.
Was a few days before my HBO special. Because remember, I was off. I took 2 days off before I shot the special because I knew I was going to need I didn't want to wake up early. I wanted to just relax and do that set. And beforehand, we had announced that this is... And Obi even said the other show, Jim won't be here Monday and Tuesday. There's nothing going on that's uncomfortable.
Oh,
that's
right.
Planned. He's not supposed to be here because he's taking off of the HBO.
Other shows would play into that.
Yeah. No, we didn't at all. We said truthfully, no.
All the speculation that was going on, though.
And these guys still came to the shows and everything. And by the time you guys came, we had talked like 2 days later. It was fine.
Oh, no. We were fine before I went to the show.
Yeah. Well, you get the shit out.
My God.
You get it out.
That would be a dick move if we didn't talk before your
HBO. Oh, yeah, no, we did.
One. Holy crap.
It's anger leaving your body. It gets out. You fucking shit.
That was a fun one.
Yeah, you called me a sandwich. The one thing that hurt, Jimmy called me a sociopath, and I just kind of know it's true.
Of course he did. Why wouldn't you just use the obvious?
I know, that wasn't exactly reaching deep.
Right, I was just like,
I'm sure Jim appreciated fuckface.
That hurt a lot.
Superman, I'm like, man, I didn't think you ever noticed that part of me before. He really does know I'm a sociopath.
Yeah, there were some great lines to that one.
We got another one, Derek? I think we're playing this one. You guys might be on the same. All right, cool. Here's another one, Louie. We go back to what we were
doing. Now we're back.
We were off the highway for a while, but now we're back on.
Turn back on.
One report from the Interfax News Agency says witnesses saw an explosion just before one of the crashes. Both planes were Tupolev Tu-154 jets. That's a standard airliner on domestic flights in Russia. The first crash happened in Bukovki, about 110 miles south of Moscow.
Bukovki?
Splattered the faces of all the people.
What is it about plane crashes and death that make anchors say cock and...
Cock.
Hunt.
Yeah. Oh, Brokaw got away with it for years.
Wow. Yeah, he did.
He couldn't even speak.
He couldn't
talk.
And he was
giving us the news.
Yeah, that L thing where he couldn't really say his L.
Weird.
Got stuck in his throat.
Like, I
bet he's betting people how much you hear me if I say cunt tonight. A United Airlines 767 took off from Cockfuck Airport this morning. Oh, wait a minute. It was York Liberty. Sorry.
Well, we'll break by this. It all started with this Jane Skinner clip that's on YouTube. Let's play it again as we go to break.
Oh,
you going?
Huh?
Where are you going?
Where are you going,
Rich?
What am I going on?
Oh, you're a little chill.
You have more audio to play.
You haven't talked in 15 minutes.
What's the matter with you?
Is that right?
I'm good. We're all talking. All the guys are talking.
Talking, laughing.
Well, you were telling that story. It's an amazing story. I wasn't butted in at all. That was a great, you know.
Open up your hands. Just once.
Oh, they're just awful. They're awful hands.
All right, we go to break with this clip again.
Evolved.
Hey, we got some Dice audio.
Oh, yeah.
If there's anyone that wants to tap out, yeah. I understand. Don't want to drag anyone else into our,
hey, Jacob.
Our bullshit, but some interesting audio.
Yeah.
And we'll play that next, but first, this clip.
The deputy police chief says six officers were killed, including the district's top cop after the vehicle they were riding in was sprayed with bullets. Three other officers were hurt in the attack. And those are your latest headlines. I'm Jane Skinner. Time now to send you back to Shepherd, who is live where? Just outside of Memphis.
South Carolina Gamecocks, she's a big fan. Go South Carolina.
Do you know how hard it is to read when everyone else in the studio is shaking with laughter at your misfortune?
I know. I've been there, Jane.
You too,
it's been worse for
just
me many billions
do
of
it
times.
Now.
Wow. It's Friday, Jane. No one's watching. They're out doing things. It's just me, you, and Dorellen down in Destin. That's it. We'll look for you on YouTube there, Jane.
Thanks so much.
There are many ways to give an Opie and Anthony wow sticker. This is not one of them.
Hello, I am selling wow stickers on Craigslist. Please buy a $4,000 American to a numbered account in Zurich, and I'll happily send you a wow sticker, shiny and new. I have a friend in the shipping industry, so shipping won't be a problem.
Get your own Opie and Anthony wow sticker. Go to opieandanthony.com and fill out the online form. We'll send you a shiny new wow sticker, and you'll be enjoying some lovely melons in no time.
Stomach hurts. I hope it's not that powder I'm taking. It makes...
back it in the New York room.
Oh,
we're back.
Back in the New York room. I'm obsessed with Ace Frehley. I have to meet him.
Why?
I'm obsessed.
You have
Why?
To beat him. What do you mean?
No, meet him. He's the only member of Kiss I haven't met. I'm obsessed
yeah.
with him.
We met him.
No. Mm-hmm.
That powder that makes your shit. What, cocaine?
You know that you're about 5,000 times more important than him now.
It does.
No, I want to meet Ace.
You should want to meet you.
Exactly.
You know, people actually come to see you now.
Celebrities never want to meet me. They don't care about me.
Edward Norton.
Erin Moran.
She was a big Lucky Louie fan. Joni from I Love from Happy Days.
Oh, really?
Her and her husband, I went to a signing, and they're like, you that guy from Lucky Louie? And I got a picture with him, and they wanted a picture with me.
Wow.
They were big fans of Lucky
Louie. Her husband,
Louie.
Chachi?
No. Charles Arcola wasn't there.
They
were divorced. Remember, he was molesting children?
I forgot about that episode. Very special. Happy Days.
That's right.
That was the happiest of all days.
Yes, where Chachi, where Donnie Most had a nephew, and Chachi fingered its ass in the booth at Owls. And then Arnold went, quiet!
I forgot that one.
Yeah.
Johnny. Yogurt.
Don't IM me, people. Don't IM. Here's what I get. Hi. Because then my screen fills up with IMs.
That's it.
So I warn people. Now I have to bounce you.
Oh, my stomach hurts.
Wait, so you're taking that powder? Aloe cleanse?
Yeah, I don't know if that's it, though. That might not be making my stomach hurt. It could just be.
I hear the powder is awful.
It tastes terrible.
I made an ass of myself with Ed Norton once.
What'd you do?
Dead, yes. Yeah. He came into the cellar to see Jeff Ross. He's putting him in a movie or something.
So Jimmy, what happened?
So
I was busy.
His big thing is Edward Norton, his good friend,
comes
down to see him.
Yes,
at the cellar.
He was there recently too.
Apparently, he goes down and sees a lot of comics and puts some of them in movies.
Yeah, but who knows what the movie's about? He couldn't need an old Walter Matthau looking man. And that's why Jeff was hired.
Perfect for the part.
But so Jeff went on and he did, did his set, and then I went on after him and. Norton stayed in the room, and I just killed. I had a great set, and so him and Jeff were hanging out in a booth upstairs afterwards, and I don't even care who Ed Norton is, but he's a celebrity, and part of me just wants him to say something nice.
Yeah.
So I kind of started standing around their booth, looking like I'm doing things I'm not doing, hoping that he's going to go, hey, you were awesome, and I just didn't get any play. I kept trying to get in his line of sight.
It was fucking pathetic.
It's fucking pathetic.
Oh, you poor bastard.
Totally helpless to those feelings. I don't know what made me do it. And then finally, I just fucking walked past their booth, which wasn't like the comics booth. It was very out of my way, looking like, oh, I'm leaving out this way anyway. And said goodbye to Jeff. Hey, Jeff, see you later. I never would say goodbye to Jeff Ross on the way out of a car. Oh, I got to say goodbye to Jeff Ross. Yes. I can't let him. In a million years, I wouldn't say goodbye to him. I fucking almost don't like him. And then Norton. So I say goodbye to Jeff, and then I finally just look him right in the fucking face and force him to. He goes, "Hey, it was good. It was good." And then continues talking to him.
Like, oh wow! Made him give you a compliment.
I made him.
Oh my god!
I made him either tell me to fuck off. I gave him a choice between tell me to fuck off or tell me I did a good job. Barely.
Sounds like he gave you a little of both.
A little of both.
Yeah, yeah.
He did.
Yeah, good. Get the fuck out of here.
Fucking useless.
You want so much validation. The other night, we're doing a benefit, and Robert Klein was headlining, but he's in the audience. I'm going, oh, great, man. I'm going on right before him. He'll watch me.
Jimmy.
You know, and he'll watch me. I'll go, it'll be great. I'll try to kill, and Robert Klein, who's a legend, will come up.
Yeah.
So I'm on stage, and right before I go up, the owner drags Robert Klein out of the room to talk to him about something. Mm-hmm. And I just wanted to kill him. Yeah. Robert Klein's wife is sitting there, however, and I'm looking to see if she's laughing and maybe try to get a compliment through her.
Yeah, my wife,
Robert Klein's wife.
I know.
You were trying to get compliments from.
That's being anointed, Robert Klein's wife. Yeah, that's
a
big moment.
It doesn't get any better than that.
That's like Johnny Carson's 3-ring sign, heaven know. Robert Klein's wife noticed that you're on stage. It's good.
Wow.
All right, why don't we get this Dice audio on?
What is this exactly? Is this the problem with one of our fans?
Yeah, we had the pests. A bunch of pests just giving them shit.
A few pests went to one of his gigs.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll happen.
For Louis C.K. Dice was a really good friend of the show, and for whatever reason, we still don't
quite
know.
A while.
He decided to turn on us bad.
We got fired. We were off for a couple of years. During that couple of years, I do believe Opie actually went out to L.A., hung out with him.
Went to
no
the
bad
gym.
Blood.
Went to the gym with him and did 10-pound curls with him, because that's how he works out.
That's what you do now.
The most bizarre thing ever.
And then
I'm like, Dice, it's too light. He goes, no, just do it 100 times. Why? It was 10-pound
Gives
curl.
You definition.
Yeah. Whatever. But then,
So there was no bad blood or anything, and then we get back on the air.
Hung out in his apartment after he got kicked out of his house. Went shopping with him. Him in a shopping cart.
Gave you tips on decorating your
You mean you put him in the cart like you put a kid in there?
Yeah, might as well have, but he's...
Mommy, I want the sweet cereal.
He's dressed as Dice with a shopping cart in a supermarket. It was pretty hilarious.
Did he have the bedazzled
Dice? I hung out with him a few nights ago. I never met him.
Yeah.
And at the Comedy Store, I saw him. He went on after me at the Comedy Store. He's a million times funnier as a stand-up than he was when he was big. I never got him. I never thought that was funny.
Yeah.
The Dice thing. But now he's just a guy talking. And it's fucking funny. Yeah, but anyway, I hung out after him. I talked to him.
Ages.
He's a nice guy. I liked him. I mean, I don't know. I have no idea what's going on.
Yeah,
with
that's fine.
But he was very.
We thought he was a nice guy.
That's
too.
How he was. That's how he'd been. I mean, for years, that's how he'd been. We had great time. Did some great shows. Some of the best shows ever. Mm-hmm. And then something happened.
Yeah.
We still don't know.
No.
I turned around, started bad mouthing us.
Mm-hmm.
For no fucking reason.
No real reason.
That's weird.
Like, he won't talk to you and say...
No, that's fine. Whatever. He could call the show anytime. He knows the numbers.
Go ahead.
If he had a problem, he could have called.
Cash it out on the air. How it should be done.
So he was doing a show, and, you know, our past, they're just terrific.
Ruthless.
So I guess in the middle of Dice's set, the past were giving it to him pretty good, where Dice just, like, exploded on stage.
Oh, no.
Growing up on your own feet, another fucking zero. I don't give a fuck.
See, he says another fucking zero because I heard, and you know we're pretty honest here, I heard at this particular show he ate his balls. He ate his balls. He was not having a good time up there and not a good set.
Where was this?
And so I guess the pests were jumping up one after another, and that's where this tape begins with another whatever.
Where was this?
I don't know where this one was.
Connecticut.
Was it Connecticut? Or...
The audio's from Saturday night.
Oh.
So is this past Saturday night?
Yeah. And I guess this was broadcast on the other...
it was?
I think so, yeah.
Doggy Channel.
Is this a show he did with Artie?
I think so.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He told me about this.
Did he? What'd he say?
He told me that there were six fist fights during this show. There were literally six fist fights during this show. Yeah. Just for full disclosure, I'm working with Dice in Albany in December. We're doing a gig.
It's all right. We'll make it perfectly clear that Louis C.K. This isn't Louis C.K.'s battle. Don't worry.
No.
He's a guy I just met and like. And
you'll be doing a show with him soon. Yeah. But,
see, I'll probably get heckled there and
there
fine,
were six
whatever.
Fist fights?
That's what he said. Yeah.
And this particular guy was getting dragged out as Dice was giving him the business.
Mm-hmm.
And they were just popping up one after another. Oh, and they passed boink, 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 boink.
Like at the Republican convention?
giving Dice shit.
4 more years.
Which he pretty much deserved, so. And Dice couldn't take it, finally.
It's throwing up on your own feet, but not a fucking zero. I don't give a fuck. This is serious radio. We do what the fuck we want when we want to fucking do it. Howard Stern's at home fucking listening. Because we got a couple fucking lambs in the crowd maybe listening in. Oh, I'm a pest from the ONHO. Now you're a pest outside in your own fucking vomit. Choke on it, you prick.
Whoa.
They're not with him on it, the crowd.
Whoa.
Huh?
The crowd's not with him.
No, I don't think so at all.
There's
some cheers in there, absolutely.
I don't know what was going on there. Wow. Mm. I guess a couple of pests got a little rambunctious.
Mm. And we love it. Absolutely love it.
This is a weird half side of comedy of stand-up, this whole world.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys and them and everybody, like how you pack theaters, like gym shows, you know, just these people are fucking nuts. I mean, your fans are crazy.
I know. Fucking psychopaths.
They show appreciation in weird ways.
Lunatics. Yeah, they'll
get
kill.
You're funny, fucking asshole! Just screaming. And
oh, that was Hampton Beach Casino.
Like, okay. Controlling a mob. Such a weird way to do stand-up.
Let's see. Okay, this guy was at the show. Mike, New Hampshire, what's up?
What's up, boys?
Hey.
I was at the show on Saturday night. I went up there and see Artie. I know. I'm a big fan of you guys, but I had to see Artie. I like that dirty work and whatnot. And Dice got up there and got fucking torn apart. It was unbelievable.
How was...
Unbelievable.
So how long into the show did all this stuff happen?
This happened... Well, Artie was supposed to be the headliner. He got up there about 25 minutes.
Call back, dude. Your phone crapped out.
Your phone.
We're losing you. Let's say hi to Diana. Deanna. California, what's up? Hey.
Remember, Louie, when you did the special for XM, like, I don't know, a couple months ago?
Oh, the one I did in D.C.?
Yeah, and the stupid drunk guy was heckling you?
Yeah.
Well, I'm from that town. I'm from Hagerstown.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wanted to tell you that we're not all like that, and that I love you. And thank you, though, for wanting to play that one.
Oh, thank you.
Oh. And I saw Dice the other night on VH1. He was plugging his bit on this. There's a black girl that has a show.
Wendy Williams.
He was on there, and he was like arguing with his little fag or her little fag assistant. It was just funny. I think he was doing a show on VH1, and then he went on VH1 to plug the show. So it was just funny. See, now he doesn't have you guys. So
Boy, she sounds a lot different when she's being taped.
Yeah.
She sounds more interesting.
When she's boring people.
Yeah, wow. Your voice changes when you get tased.
Yeah.
Way to spin a yarn.
Oh, my God.
Way to rivet a nation.
I like when they stick it for their town. We're not all drunk losers.
Yeah, no, that guy was a fucking drip.
All right, we got a contest announcement. A contest announcement.
Ooh. Oh, boy.
It's the ONA video contest sponsored by HotMovies.com.
Let's see how this works.
It starts today.
It starts
today officially. It will end on December 15th. Grand prize, $1,000, courtesy of HotMovies.com. It's an ONA-themed video contest.
All right.
Original videos or animation, no more than 3 minutes each, submitted via email, VHS, DVD.
Wait, if somebody comes and submits a VHS tape, I am going to go to their house and shove it up their ass.
Ooh.
There is no way VHS should be in our vocabulary anymore.
It's the dumbest.
Boss, you have a VHS, right?
Beta.
Betamax? Yeah.
All right, you know what? I got to go back to the Dice thing because people are just dumb. TJ from Jersey. Ope, maybe Dice hates you because you never called him back after he tried to call you after your father died.
Oh, really?
Well, he had fun talking about my father and my dead dad's skull on Howard's show, so go fuck yourself, first of all, TJ. Second of all, I wasn't talking to many people after my dad died. Sorry.
Yeah, maybe you need a little time to mull things over.
That's a weird reason to get mad at somebody.
Right. Yeah.
Sorry that
his father dies and he gets all fucking snotty.
Yeah, well, what happened?
Sorry that I kept to myself and actually had no desire to even do radio for the first 6 months when we got on XM. So he takes that I didn't call him. After my father died.
He didn't want to go to Pips.
Got so pissed off that he still didn't call our show, then starts bad-mouthing us, and then goes on Howard, even though he's going to call me about my father, because he knew that crushed me, and then starts discussing how he's going to fuck my dead dad's skull, right? Fuck you, TJ. Fuck you. Also, Jimmy, no comment about Dice, still friends with him, or figuring you could hop on his coattails.
Well, that's true.
No, to be honest with you, I've talked to Andrew once in the last 2 years. I never lie about what happened with me and him. He just booted me off the tour, me, him, and Florentine while we were off the air. And, I hated that it happened like that. And then he didn't come on the show. And I saw him once when I was out in L.A. and we talked for like an hour. And that's when I was out there shooting Lucky Louie, and we hadn't talked since.
Yeah, Dice does stupid things, and there's no real explanation for it.
Okay. I have no personal issue with Dice. I just don't like him anymore, because no one else does. Nah, I'm a bandwagon jumper.
There's no reason to be ashamed of that.
He actually
just
said
well, other folks were going that way, so I figured that sounds good to me.
So I said, I'm going to be with all them, because I want to be like everybody else.
Well, I admire those people, and they're doing it, so I'm going to do what they do.
I'm getting on the bandwagon.
What? Yeah.
He actually had
what's wrong with bandwagons?
Some dumb stuff to say about you,
Tom. Of course he does.
He's a douchebag. O&A theme video contest. Original videos or animation, no more than 3 minutes each. Submitted via email, VHS tape, DVD, that are centered around the cast and crew of the O&A show. And details are on opieandanthony.com. We're going to host the videos on opieandanthony.com and foundrymusic.com.
Can they use clips from the show?
Yeah.
Can they use video from the show that has found its way to various locations online?
Huh?
You mean can they edit it?
Why no? Let's say they go to some of these, a lot of these video sites.
Yeah.
And pick and choose certain clips and then edit them together in a humorous fashion.
With some commentary voiceover.
Right, voiceover music, or, things like that.
What if they superimpose penises going in your mouths?
Right.
That kind of thing.
Here's the winning submission right now. Yeah. I'm just going to give it out. What if they take us, video, put it in fast motion, and put the Benny Hill music behind it?
Oh, fucking
Now I just gave out the winning one. I just fucked the whole contest.
There you go. Well, videos will be judged on originality, humor, relevance to the O&A show.
So get it where you can.
Sponsored by HotMovies.com. Mm-hmm. Well, like the Dragon Wagon clip's a perfect example. When Jimmy went after that Dragon Wagon guy and the kid animated it, it's getting massive views on all the websites.
Yeah, if you know Flash Animation, you're
Newsgrounds,
autistic.
Whatever. Got to be 18 and older. It's sponsored by HotMovies.com.
All right.
Really fast, TJ's writing back. Ope, I wasn't calling you out, just stating a point that you guys talked about earlier, previously, when you talked about Dice and him hating you. Okay. And then we got David Jones from MS. Where's that? MS is
Mississippi or Massachusetts.
Sclerosis.
Mississippi.
Wow, Opie's touchy when someone in his family dies. It's fucking comedy gold when it happens to someone else. No laugh track, Ope? Hey, guys, my dad died in a fiery car accident.
That's terrific. That's terrific.
There you go. Dude.
Yeah. Now what?
Now what? Ass.
I feel queasy.
You all right?
I like how they got backed off. I get emails sometimes from people, like on MySpace, people write me messages, and I read all of them, but I answer close to zero because I have kids and I work.
You're a busy guy.
And also, that's not interesting to do.
Right.
So I don't do it.
Answering all of them.
So sometimes the only ones I answer are people that say, hey, asshole, I've written you three times. You won't answer. You don't care about your fans. I'm no longer your fan. I hate you, you piece of shit. So I write back and I say, well, I'm busy. And if you don't like me because of that, fuck you. And then they always write back and go, I totally wasn't trying to,
man.
You know, I just totally, no.
No.
I made up this one thing that I keep on my clipboard, on my notepad, that I can just take off, copy and paste when people really bash me. Mm-hmm. And it's a real, like, I got to pull it up. it's a real kind of generic stamped response. Like, that's all I give. It's like, thank you so much for supporting the program.
Thank you for your interest
in
Anthony.
We really appreciate it here at the Opie and Anthony show. Like, I just slam him with that. He took all this time to write what a dickhead I am and how unfunny the show is and fuck. And I just send him this generic thing.
You just let him know that they're going on a pile, like they're adding to a number. We are happy to get emails.
Didn't read your fucking letter. I just sent this off. Fuck you.
You know what you said? You told us, and I tried that one time, and then I didn't get enough satisfaction. I have to fight with them.
Yeah, you're crazy.
Never.
You fight.
You never do that.
You get into message board wars.
That's crazy.
That's just, I just write. I hit the message board, but usually it's one post where it's just like, go fuck all he is.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Oh, sorry, dude. I like the message boards for the most part, but there are bits we do that are so obviously just great.
We know. Greatness.
No, I'm serious. And then you go on the message board, and 95% of the people, they're with you. Yeah, that was obviously those guys doing comedy gold, what have you. Then you get these asses.
That's what you get. It's either...
But they want to be...
It's either, well, you gotta take, comedy's either very subjective, some people aren't gonna like the funniest thing in the world, some people just aren't gonna like. And the other thing is, some people just wanna be too cool for the room, like, you know.
Well, also, Americans aren't, they're consumers when it comes to, like, movies or anything. Mm-hmm. It's not like there's art that they're appreciating and then thinking of or absorbing. They think that they think they're their customer. Like, I didn't get my thing I like.
Yeah.
Well, then fuck you.
I'm not satisfied.
Yeah.
This isn't the best breakfast I ever had. Yeah. Could you bring me like manager, this. Brad?
Yeah, but they're so arrogant when they tell you how to do your job that you've been doing forever. You know, well, you say, you know what? Go up during the check spot in front of 300 drunks, all right? Man, you're dirty. Go fuck yourself.
That's why on the show we beg the message boards to eat their own. Just eat your own. You know who the problems are. You know they have nothing to contribute, that they're not official fans of the show. Just eat your own.
The
thing is, the survival in this shit is just cut and dry. If you're not good, nobody will listen and you'll stop being on the air. It'll take care of itself.
There won't be message boards about you or your shows or anything like that.
But there's bits we do, we know some will like and some whatever. Mm-hmm. But then there are those bits. It's like, if you're a fan, you call yourself a fan of the show, you're going to love it.
Mm-hmm. But
and then you get these idiots like,
you're never going to make everyone happy. It's just the way it is. Ron and Fez do this thing, message board gossip. I was listening to it yesterday. And I guess Steve put together the intro to it.
Yeah.
If that's on the fucking Dillette, you got to hear, this is some more Steve awfulness.
Oh, really?
Oh, my God, it's hard.
Really fast, I said I didn't feel like talking when my dad died.
Yeah.
You know, first 6 months of XM was a little rough for me. We discussed that in the past. Well, this guy from his cell phone, hey, Ope, you didn't feel like talking when your dad died? I didn't know your dad died the day before you were on Letterman. Sorry.
Oh, see. You know.
Hey, man, that's funny. He's gone. Let's go to Andrew in Brooklyn. Andrew.
Hey, how's it going? I just want to defend you, Ope.
Yeah.
When the guy from Don and Mike's, his wife died, you know, you guys didn't trash him.
Wow, we didn't even touch that. Of course not.
Yeah, I know.
There are things you just don't fuck with. There are things that are serious and, you know, and then the things you just don't fuck with that. It's too real. It's too close to home. It definitely surpasses any radio war bullshit. Mm-hmm. Radio wars.
Yeah.
Pretty low on the fucking ladder of importance in life when, you know, you're stricken with something.
Are you all right, Jimmy?
Is Jimmy throwing up?
He is throwing up. He said his stomach hurt because of some powder he was taking to make him shit.
Oh my God, that is authentic.
Oh no, you've got a real problem. Jimmy is vomiting into the ash
can. What happened, Jimmy?
That's made myself puke. I feel queasy.
You just made yourself puke?
Yeah.
You stuck your fingers
just right over there by all the people? You couldn't go to the fucking toilet?
I thought that was like emergency.
Yeah, so did I. No. That was like, hey, let me do this for a second.
Did stuff come up?
A little bit, but not that much. I don't know if it's a powder or not. I might just have a stomach bug.
Yeah. Oh, well, at least we all got to watch fucking brown come out of your mouth.
Oh, bile.
Oh, God.
Oh, Jesus.
They don't do this on Sean Hannity's talk show.
Yeah.
unless they're liberals.
Yeah, right. Yeah, they're probably doing it today.
Yeah. Who won it? Oh, no. Yeah.
All right, what are we doing? They have the Ron and Fez thing, and I got to leave right at 11 today.
Oh, it's a quick jingle.
All right.
It's just a jingle type intro to the segment.
I'm looking at houses again.
And it's
so
Steve.
I gotta take a look.
He goes, razzle dazzle. Listen to the way he says razzle dazzle.
Razzle dazzle. It's Bored Gossip with Eastside Dave.
A little gossip, a little.
That's it. Razzle dazzle.
Ugh.
I heard that yesterday. I couldn't get it out of my fucking head. I wanted to punch Steve in the face with that razzle dazzle. There he is. Steve.
Let me out of my fucking misery.
That is so bad.
What's wrong?
Razzle dazzle.
I think I must have. Is this working? Yeah. I think I must have cut that 3 months ago. I have no idea what happens to these lines after Dave asks for them. He just says how he wants it said.
Yeah.
He says, all right, I just need a real happy razzle dazzle. And I have no idea where it's going after that.
Well, it stunk.
Could you say razzle dazzle like there's a cock right by your chin?
Exactly.
That was really the motivation. Thanks, Jim.
Razzle dazzle.
Just try to imagine male genitalia hanging somewhere near my face and it comes out like that.
All right, thank you, Steve.
You're welcome.
Did I really say this once?
What'd you say?
Gordy from Connecticut. Opie had the best line of all time. Opie once stated that Dana Reeves died because an angel was tired of wiping Christopher Reeves' ass. I don't remember me.
What?
That. I don't remember saying that.
Wow. Like the angel said, look, get her up here.
Yeah, I'm sick
tired
of
this
shit.
Fucking dude.
Wow.
He's an adult. I shouldn't be doing this.
Yeah.
All right.
With Christopher Reeves in heaven, wouldn't he have legs that worked?
Well, I also like you still so. Shit in heaven.
Yeah.
Still,
I know, so much stuff just doesn't make sense. Yeah.
Let's go to Ken in Florida. Ken.
Hey, boys, love you. Hey, I want your side open. Believe me, I love you guys. But now I heard Dice through audio on the internet that he says you screamed at his kid, and that's why he's pissed off. I want to get your side, man. I love you guys. I'm out.
Scream at his kid?
No. What he's referring to is when he was playing Madison Square Garden, which we pretty much promoted to the point where we got people in the seats, even though the Yankees and Mets were in the World Series.
Game five.
That was a great time to do a fucking show.
But we still got people in Madison Square Garden for Dice.
Yeah.
I'm sure we can find the audio. He thanks us and says, if it wasn't for you guys, you know, this wouldn't happen. It was a dream come true that I could do this in front of my kids again, blah, blah, blah. He came down, and there was an entourage, and Dice was basically telling us that he invited Mancow to the show. And Mancow was on TV pretty much promoting that he was the one bringing Dice to New York City to the Garden.
Yeah, it was O&A Presents. Yeah.
But Mancow was trying to, like, take credit for this whole Dice at the Garden because Dice used to do his show as well. So we lost it with Dice. And now Dice is trying to claim, even though we did the show after that and we continued to be friends, he continued doing the radio show.
Yeah, nothing happened then.
When we got fired, I was out in L.A. a bunch of times hanging out with him. That is what he's claiming is the reason
that's what
why
he picked up on.
He hates me because I yelled at his kids. It just didn't happen.
Well, that's bullshit because after the Garden, he did a beacon and he was still
absolutely.
In
it just
fucking
didn't happen.
Everything was still fine and dandy.
He would bring his kid in a lot. So the only thing I can tell you is maybe when Aunt and I, because Aunt was part of this too, because we were out of our minds that all of a sudden Mancow A was going to show up at the Garden show. We hated him for the shit he was saying about us. You know, we were going at it with Dice on the show live, and if his kid was in the area, that's the only thing I could think of.
Imagine if every relationship you had in your life was the other person was on the radio.
Like a radio war, yeah.
Yeah, just, I mean, any relationship would turn into that.
Everyone.
Because everybody on the planet Earth that has any relationship with anybody says, you know, when they walk away from him, you fucking cunt, I hate him. I mean, everybody.
Yeah.
You know, your wife, your kid, everybody goes like, okay, great, see you later, you fucking cunt. So if everybody in the world went on to their own separate radio shows after talking to each other, this
and then
just
started
happened.
Talking about it.
Yeah.
Right. That's why radio, you get the radio wars, because
that's why
people can't just get on the air and keep their mouths shut.
No.
Yeah, I met that guy, he said this, what a fucking asshole, and then he gets on, these guys are fucking douchebags.
No, the default human relationship is animosity, covered by politeness.
It's
and
default.
That's why the radio has so much fun. This jackass cop gave me a ticket for no reason the other night. I go, do you listen to O&A? He goes, yeah. I go, well, I'm going to trash you. And he got happy that I was... Yeah.
Really? You're going to measure me?
Yeah.
No jackass cops.
Didn't he recognize your name?
Yeah, but...
But I just want to make this perfectly clear. Our side of the story, that was the only time we actually had a real fight with Dice, because it was like, what are you doing, man? Mm. You know, we hate Mancow, and you're going to, you know, he's going to come down and be at the Garden Show after we just helped, you know, you promote this.
Yeah, if he wanted to go to Chicago and sell out a show over there, then let him fucking, you know, hook up with Mancow there. Like, we wouldn't give a shit about that.
Right.
That's one thing, and this is God's honest, we don't care who goes on what show. Doesn't fucking matter. We know you, especially comics, have to plug their gigs. They want the biggest audience there is. So if you guys are playing, and especially if it's a market we're not even in, I mean, who gives a shit what shows you go on and plug your gigs? Same thing with the little actors, actresses. Why should we care if they're plugging their movie on another radio show? Some people, they don't want you fucking going on other shows. We've been cock-blocked 1,000 fucking times, and we could give a shit whose show anyone else goes on. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. What was Howard saying? Something about Otto and George?
I don't know. I didn't hear any of the audio.
Because of the FHM thing? Apparently, because Otto and George is prominently featured in our FHM article this month. And he said something like, oh, well, he's over with their camp now. Like, it's a camp. Like, anyone cares. Do whatever you got to do to promote what the fuck you do in life. It's not going to matter to me. I could give a shit.
Right. But just to end it, so then after that argument we had with Dice, we ended up staying friends for a long time after that with never another altercation, ever.
Yeah.
Nothing with me yelling at his kids. That's just a flat-out lie. Did not yell at Dice's
kids. No, no one yelled at his kids.
Why would you yell at his kids? Why would you? Like, what reason could there be to yell at his kids?
Put a booger on the couch.
All right. That, if that ever happened, I would have to yell and then throw away the couch.
I believe he's got mental problems. I got to say, he's nuts. Yeah. He's just fucking nuts.
I don't think you'd be alone thinking that, talking to people that know him. But
that's coming from me. He's nuts. Sponsored by BodogFight.com. We're talking about line of the day. Yes, log on and watch American fighters battle for the right to represent the U.S. in a bout against the Russians. It's all on BodogFight.com. A mixed martial arts tournament and docu-reality unlike any seen before.
I must crush you.
We got a couple runner-up lines of the day and then the winner, of course. Here's the first runner-up.
I call my girl Mother when I'm having sex with her.
Mother? Mother blood!
I'll actually call her by my mother's maiden name.
I go with Granny myself.
Grandma.
Oh, Nana.
Oh, God damn.
It's even worse, though, if you only go from behind and you call her Pop-Pop. Oh, Pop-Pop.
Very
Norton,
good, Jimmy.
Line of the day. Runner-up. Here's the other runner-up line of the day.
Oh, there's another runner-up. Okay.
Yeah. Let's say hi to Rich. He has an apology for Louis C.K. Oh.
Rich Voss.
Rich in New Hampshire.
Apology for everybody.
He's an apology for XM Canada. And go ahead, Rich.
Outside a toilet store with a mouthful of polywogs.
I
made runner-up.
How could that not be line of the day?
That's pretty great.
You guys found a better one than that today?
That's all right. I accept their judgment.
Well, no, voting's anonymous.
I'm bloop single guy.
Dan's not happy with the winner.
Oh, really?
I can tell. This should be the winner.
Uh-oh.
I thought when Ann said that, there's no way that's going to be beat.
I'll agree with you.
Well.
Well, let's see what the winner was.
Yeah.
Yeah, Louis C.K.'s in there like, I know which one it is. Here's line of the day.
Oh. Oh, Danny, you suck.
Comes.
Danny sucks.
Line of the day. Line of the day. Line of the day.
Razzle dazzle.
Really?
All right, they're trying to make a funny bit out of it.
Wow, the boys behind the scenes trying to
make it funny. Okay, whose idea was that? There was one person. Two people don't automatically go, let's do this. One person came up with that idea. Who was it?
You guys might have just wrecked the line.
Who was it? It was fucking Travis. Travis, you actually thought that was funny. You thought we were going to, like, laugh. Ah, look, line of the day is just Steve saying razzle dazzle.
You just took a winner from Anthony.
Why would you make a bit out of the bit?
Oh, no. I said in jest, that should just be line of the day.
Yeah.
Everyone laughed and said yes, and then we said, we'll play that, and then we'll play the real one.
Now he's smearing it around the responsibility.
Oh, wait, there's a real one after that?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that wasn't line of the day?
No, that was just...
Oh, we're all dicks then. Sorry. Okay. Go back to your post.
That was a funny one.
We're all assholes. Sorry.
I still don't know how fucking polywogs didn't win.
Wow, we still don't get it.
It was just an opportunity to make fun of Steve one last time and then do the real line of the day.
Okay.
Well, I think that...
Yeah, I think that's just hurtful.
All right. Here's maybe Steve. It's only funny to girls. I don't know. Travis.
Right. Steve saying razzle dazzle is fucking... No wonder I threw up.
Here's the official line of the day.
I have to literally scrape shit out of my daughter's little red vagina a few times a day. A few
times
a day.
Oh, my God.
Got to get in there
hard.
With the wipey, make a corner out of it, and get the shit out of it.
Holy
every time she takes
fuck.
A shit, it goes straight up her gut.
It's true.
That's really
that
true.
Is a good
yeah,
one.
Man, that's hard to
you know something?
That's
you're rare. It's something you rarely hear, too.
And that was actually on PFM, and it didn't get dumped.
Louis, you killed for us. Sorry it got a little weird near the end there.
No.
Show got a little weird at the end, but...
That always does. Stupid show.
And Louis, what, next weekend we'll be
Vegas,
in the Vegas Comedy Festival.
TheComedyFestival.com or LouisCK.com. I'm at the Vegas. Me and Dave Attell together with Daniel Tosh also.
That's
very
a great
funny show,
man.
Yeah, it should be good.
Yeah, you got to stay in touch and
definitely.
Stop by anytime, man.
Absolutely. Thank you, guys.
A lot of fun.
Thanks.
Absolutely.
And Jimmy, where are you?
Hammerstein Ballroom, Friday night.
Hammerstein.
I feel better since I puked.
Do you?
Yeah. Hammerstein Ball. I only got a little bit out. It wasn't the food. It was
I like how you were throwing up as Steve was talking.
Yeah, no. Just who listens to him? I just went to shut up. Hammerstein Ballroom Friday night and Ticketmaster. It'll be a good show. I have a lot of new filth.
All right. And the inimitable Rich Voss.
Sweetie.
The Helium Comedy Club, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Philly. Helium Comedy Club. I don't know how you made yourself throw it with just one finger when you're used to
I can't believe you do it in the room with people. The whole point of a bathroom is that you fucking put your waste products
in
another area.
Rich, just because yours don't go past your front teeth.
Exactly.
He's trying to make a cock-gagging joke.
No, I wasn't.
But yes,
you were. You were.
No, I was saying how he didn't go into the bathroom.
Yes, you were.
No, you said because he's used to taking a little more in his mouth.
Can you just let it pass? It's the end of the day.
No.
Couldn't just let it go?
Never.
You just had a...
I gave you a great compliment today. I said that you're great on a stage.
Thank you. Oh, fuck it, I do my job here. Fuck.
He is. He's funny.
Breathe some of that fart in. That's a putrid fart I just dropped.
Oh no. Oh, then I want the fuck out of here.
I want to see my girlfriend and give her the old Dutch oven.
I am not going
to... You got a new girlfriend?
I have to clear the path like a machete through the fucking farm.
Look at Anthony.
Yeah. Hacking with
we all have problems on this show. Have you noticed yet, Louis? Louis's noticed. That's why he wants to hang out here.
Then you need the Purell. Oh, you got a Purell up a little bit, and then you got... And talking about cleaning all the germs in his house, and we're all looking at each other like, yeah, this is fucking normal.
One stupid booger. No, we could all relate.
It was a child booger.
You obviously never lived in a fraternity house.
Yeah, totally.
Thank God I didn't have to shove marshmallows up my ass and walk 10 yards.
I had a guy that would sleep naked on the couch at my fraternity, and he would be so wasted, and then he would...
You could fuck him, and he wouldn't know it.
No, he would...
No?
He would splatter shit on the walls.
Jeez.
He would have the explosive diarrhea while he was passed out in the living room on one of those fucking flea-infested couches. It's a true story.
All right, let's be honest. His name, Greg.
No. There was a big fat guy, Jerry. I forgot his last name, but... true story. Explosive diarrhea all over the walls from this guy, and completely passed out naked. Oh, having explosive diarrhea. And you're worried about a booger.
Was he a member of the fraternity, or he just hung out?
Yeah,
you couldn't throw him out.
You guys went to college.
I'm a legacy. Me?
I didn't go to college.
No, fuck that. I didn't.
You really need to say that, Voss?
Rich.
Why don't you just say I can't fly either?
Rich is trying to brag there. Look at all the knowledge I have, and I didn't go to college.
I didn't go to college. She's a hard knock.
Sometimes
a hard knock.
Shut up.
Wouldn't surprise me if you didn't get out of third grade.
Rich was expecting all of us to go, oh, really?
What? You didn't go to college?
As well spoken as you are?
That's impossible.
Bye. All right.
Bye, listeners.
Wow, look, the mics were still on. All right, take it easy. Good night, everybody.
Goodbye.
See you tomorrow. Have a good one. Fan, it's all yours.
Yes, fan.
Later.
Line four. Yeah, just sitting there. No.
The Opie and Anthony Show presents a Wild Bill production. Ooh, 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 ooh
Hey, kid, need a ride?
Mister, what's that bumper sticker on your car?
That's a wow sticker.
What's a wow sticker?
Now, you look tired. Need a ride home?
What's a wow sticker?